is Dilhara Fernando to bowl the first ball of the evening. Oh, good pace and bounce there. I've got Tom Moody and Tony Gregg alongside me. Tom Moody, the local favourite here. And Tony Gregg, all sorts of conflicts for you this year. Sri Lanka to start the summer and England later on. Who are you going for?
Isn't this just wonderful? Yeah, always, as you know, I've had a soft spot for these little Sri Lankans. Way back to 1996, I'm sure you remember it well.
It was before that, surely. 96? You're kidding. I thought it was about 66 when you started sporting them.
Sri Lanka beat Australia in that World Cup final. Tubby Taylor was there, took it on the chin. And they've played some good cricket since then. They're entertaining, very entertaining side. Of course, Tom has coached them.
He's got that away. Not convincingly, but he's off the mark and Australia away.
Already we can see there's quite a bit of pace and bounce in this wicket. David Warner was rushed on that occasion. Fernando digging the ball in and getting good lift. Warner just managing to keep that down.
Yes, that was onto him very fast. He didn't really know much about that, did he? Managed to control it. Big challenge for him here not to go berserk. I mean, he hits them hard enough without having to do anything too silly early on. Just get his eye in a bit. He's down the non-striker's end now.
Oh, that's good pace. Bounce, carry through to the keeper. Michael Clark has elected to bat himself at the top of the order. I think that's a good move. There's been a bit of talk about Michael Clark. Michael Slater was talking about it earlier tonight, about how he's under a bit of pressure. Scores at strike rate about 103, which is just over a run of ball, which in one day cricket would be superb. At this form of the game, I suppose it's underachieving. So he's got himself up the order to try and, I suppose, stamp his authority on the game and try and get a big score. On his away once again. A bit like Dave Warner, not convincing. Inside edge, couldn't have been too far from leg stump.
This will some quick bowling. He doesn't mind bowling the odd bouncer either. In fact, more than the odd bouncer. Good delivery, this one. Dragged in past the leg stump. That's where you need a break or two as a bowler in this format.
Absolutely. He does work up some good pace. But the other thing to look out for with Dilhara Fernando is his change of pace. He's got a very good change of pace with a slower ball that he pitches up and also the slower ball bouncer, which has become very vogue in this form of the game.
Oh, that's the way Dave Warner plays. That might have been that slow one you talked about, Tom.
Yeah, I think you can hear us from up here. Yeah, that was well below. That was 129 kilometres an hour, so a good change. The split finger slower ball he has, Dilhara Fernando. And he has the ability to change that very late in his bowling action. So from a batting point of view, it's very hard to pick up.
Yeah, I think that's the feature of it. I think he changes it later than anyone I've ever seen. It's almost in that the arm as it goes around. He changes his grip, which is very difficult to pick up.
Oh, it's a good over. Very good over for now. That one's 141 to back up the slower ball. Beautifully bowled. Just two from the first over.
Wins International Summer of Cricket brought to you by our telecast partners. KFC, proud to go in and bat for the Australian cricket team. The Next G-Force, now introducing the Big Pond Ultimate device. And our sponsors, The Good Guys, pay less, pay cash. Amy, lucky you're with Amy. VB, the real beer. Mitsubishi Triton, love that car. And Bunnings Warehouse, where lowest prices are just the beginning.
Confirmation there of the Australian batting order. Michael Clark there at the top of the order. Shane Watson listed to bat at three. He's been in great form for Australia in all forms of the game. Cameron White at four. David Hussey there at five. There's Shane Watson, middle of your pitcher there with the pads on. No Michael Hussey in the side. He left out to play a Sheffield Shield match for Western Australia over in Adelaide, as has Mitchell Johnson, who also plays for Western Australia in the Shield competition. Here's Malinga. Clark can't beat mid on.
Just worthwhile mentioning for those of you wondering what the par score is here. The Wacker is a fast outfield. It's a pitch. The ball comes onto the bat nicely. So we're looking at something in the order of 160. Score 160 and you've done pretty well.
Yeah, the other thing at the Wacker, it's quite a hard ground to defend. So, you know, you need to make sure you get every bit of 160. So Michael Clark will be looking very much at 160 plus.
That was an attempted slow ball. It's obviously not come out too well from Malinga. In the end, it wasn't as harmful as it looked.
Yeah, it always gives you a fright as a batsman when you're seeing the ball coming up around your rib cage when it hasn't pitched. But Malinga bowls the slower ball like an off break. And you can appreciate with a slingy action, it's quite hard to control. But normally he does control it very well.
The clock got his elbow out of the way really quickly there. That would have been nasty.
Chance if he can hit. A good running from Warner. He's very quick, David Warner. He's a solid, shortish man, but he's very quick. Good fieldsman. Obviously a very powerful man. You can see his arms. He hit the ball a long way, but he's also very quick. Hit and run, really. Got home comfortably in the end.
Well, in 2020 cricket, there's just no room for hesitation. You've got to back the judgment of the caller, and you've got to go. And it's very hard for a fielding side to stop any pair from pinching singles if they're both on the case and both looking for the one. So the Sri Lankans will be ready to pounce on this opportunity when it comes again.
That's a wide. Trouble getting it right at the moment, Malinga. He has got that unusual slinging type action. And because he is a round arm type bowler and doesn't come over the top, he can have trouble with line and length. When he gets it right, he's awkward. When he gets it wrong, it's like that.
Yes, batsmen have been known to get the umpire to take things like white hats off because he's so low and the ball can sometimes, the background can be a hat, an umpire's hat.
Well hit, straight to mid-off.
There's the Sri Lankan spinner, Murali. What a fine player he has been for over a long period of time. David Warner opening his shoulders on this occasion, but not getting it past Murali at mid-off.
Didn't take long to get rid of the slip. He's gone straight to short extra cover. Kumar Sangakkara, the wicketkeeper, captain of this side. Wonderful player, wonderful cricketer.
Once again, he's not going to beat Murali there at mid-off. How about that last replay we showed there of Dave Warner's face? This is what 2020 cricket is all about. Just watch this. He's already starting to grit his teeth. The bowler hasn't even looked like letting go of the ball at this stage. And when he does, it's really, let's get down to it. Throw the technique out the door a bit and hit it hard.
Do you reckon he's premeditated? Do you think he's thinking, regardless, wherever this ball is, it's going?
Yeah, I think he probably is. Certainly the way he got rid of that front leg, both of them have gone screaming at Murali Dhiran. He's rubbing his hands at the moment. In fact, he's now being moved all the way back to the boundary. Fine leg comes up.
That's nicely bowled. Another slower ball there for Malinga. Already the Sri Lankans have worked out this is an excellent pitch. It looks like a very flat, true surface to me. And you're seeing lots of changes of pace. And what you don't want to do here at the Wacker is bowl with any width.
This is a good start by the Sri Lankan bowlers. This is exactly what you want. Things can go so wrong. All you need is someone like Warner to get a couple of fours or a six away early on. And it can look quite nasty. No boundaries yet.
More chance if he can hit this time. No, he can't. And they'll get a run as well. Clark survived. He was out by a metre if he could hit.
That's exactly what Tom Moody was saying. You just got to respond to the call of the batsman down the other end. It's no wicket for seven.
Wins International Summer of Cricket, brought to you by the Next G-Force. Now introducing the Big Pond Ultimate Device.
Hello again, hello. Just called to say hello.
Well, the Sri Lankan bowlers have started particularly well. No wickets as yet, but Michael Clarke probably lucky to still be there. Tillakaratna Dilshan had a real opportunity with that last ball of the previous over. Now Clarke can't beat point. They're fielding well. They just can't hit the stumps.
Oh, Matthews fielding brilliantly on this occasion. This is what you need. This is the run-out chance. Look, he sends him back. He's halfway down the pitch. Oh, he would have been out by miles. Can't do that.
I was a little surprised with Dilshan there that he elected to throw overarm. He was coming in, had an opportunity with the ball down at that level just to follow through with an underarm throw. Either way, Clarke was gone if he could hit. And once again, can't beat point. Can't find the gaps at the moment, the Australians. And the Sri Lankans are throwing themselves everywhere.
I think what you'll see with this Sri Lankan side is that they are a very good fielding side. On that occasion, it was Chamara Kapalgetara at backward point. We've got Angelo Matthews as well in at point. Not afraid to throw it either. Someone coming around to back up. So good team effort all round.
Yeah, this was brilliant fielding by Matthews. Watch this.
This time he's got it through. Plenty of men on the offside. In the end, Michael Clarke says, we're going to change my tactics. Lovely pull shot to hit the first boundary of the evening. Important, I reckon, in this form of the game to turn the momentum around. It can be a tough game, I think, as a batsman, even though it is a batsman's game. That when you do start picking the field out, you get very hard on yourself. And your previous delivery there, Michael Clarke was shaking his head, couldn't find a gap. Now he's got a boundary. Now the momentum's already changed in his favour.
Just to pick up on that point, Mark, there's a huge responsibility for both the openers to get off to a strong start, because they're doing the batting during the power play. They're doing the batting when only two players or two fieldsmen can be out on the boundary. On this occasion, for Michael Clarke, we've got third man back and we've got deep square back on the leg side. So there's huge expectation by the whole team that you've got to get us off to a solid start. Give us a platform we can work from.
Down to third man for a single. Just to finish off that point that Tom Moody was talking about, these first six overs of a 20-over game, very important. They are the power play overs for the batting side, so only two men allowed outside that big oval you can see there, that big circle. Quite often in these early overs, you'll see that changing regularly. You'll see the fine leg back at various times and then mid-off going back. It rotates a lot depending on what the bowler's going to bowl, whether he's going to bowl a slower ball or a bouncer. But it's really important. This is probably the easiest time to hit a boundary because only two men are allowed outside. Right, straight up in the air. This should be out. Big wicket. Dave Warner's gone. Good pressure from the Sri Lankans, and Fernando gets the wicket.
Yes, very important to get rid of one of the top players, especially a danger player like Warner. Pereira took the catch there. He was very composed underneath it. This has been a good start for Sri Lanka.
Yeah, well bowled, Dilhara Fernando. He's built the pressure up here, and Warner looking to go over the top for the boundary. And not getting it outside the 30-yard circle. Australia now 1 for 12.
We were bickering away before we crashed into a farmer's crop.
I was trying to launch my boat.
I was in some kind of joke.
I just didn't see the lobby.
What about me? I never claim.
And he gets the same as I did.
What about me?
Amy Safe Driver Rewards for drivers who don't claim.
Lucky.
So three overs gone here, Australia winning the toss, electing to bat first, and there have been three excellent overs for Sri Lanka so far. Australia 1 for 12, Shane Watson batting three in this match. Dave Warner, the man out, pulled off the last ball of Dilhara Fernando's over. Watson coming to the crease, change of tactics, a change of bowlers, who tie Murali Dhiren straight into the attack.
Well, they've obviously done a lot of thinking about this. This is very interesting. Murali Dhiren with the two men back that he's allowed, one at mid-on and one at mid-wicket, so he's obviously going to have to bowl relatively straight. We know Watson loves to hit the ball straight down the ground in the air. He's a wonderful straight hitter.
Straight away off the mark. Oh, this is a great move. Forces both Clark and Watson, who are conventional type players, not really hitters of the ball, they are stroke players, to play some big shots in these power play overs.
Yes, Fernando's wicket. This was the last over. Good pressure by the Sri Lankans and well caught by Pereira. They'll be pleased with this start.
Well, Michael Clark is coming on strike now. He's probably considered one of the better players of spin bowling in the Australian side. But as I said a moment ago, he's not a hitter of the ball. He generally works the ball around very well. But there's only, 2.5 overs left in these power plays. Straight away goes over mid-off. Beautiful use of the feet. And about six rows back.
That is a magnificent shot. You can't play a lofted drive better than that one. First ball from one of the great bowlers of all time, and he's hit it straight into the crowd at mid-off.
Well, his last innings in India, just recently in a one-day international, he scored 100, and he's showing a bit of that confidence here. First ball he faces off Murali, uses his feet quickly, gets down, and hits it sweetly over mid-off. Hey!
It's going to be a nice little battle now. Clark's got himself going. Lovely use of the feet. Look at him. A couple of paces down. Try to hit it too hard. Just timed it over mid off.
He's bowling him a little quicker and a little flatter now. And what's more, he's also got that Dusra up his sleeve. And Michael Clark keeps coming down the pitch. You want to make sure he's got it covered.
Well, any bowler doesn't like being hit for a boundary, but Murali despises it.
In the end, quite well played. Unconventional. Once again, charging down the pitch, using his feet, as he did with the six. Just chipped it down to mid-on for a single.
Yes, he's 10 kilometres faster than he normally is. He normally bowls around about the 81 kilometres an hour mark.
It's a pretty good comeback in the end from Murali. Eight from the over, which included the six. And that six, that was a lovely shot. And we've got a couple of new gadgets for you, gimmicks this year, I suppose, on the coverage. We can now measure how far a ball is hit. And that six hit by Michael Clark, 97 metres. So about 90 metres to the fence and another seven into the crowd.
So that's the carry. Yeah, and quite right. I mean, this is exactly the way it should be. We should know how big a six it is. We, over the years, have talked about big sixes. Well, our big, we know that one was 97. So it'll be interesting to see what the biggest six is of the season.
Michael Clark will love it too. He can say, I've got the biggest six of the summer, 97 metres. I reckon it'll get beaten.
Somehow I don't think it's going to last. But we have seen some very big sixes here at the WACA over the years. One that really stands out to me is Mark Waugh's off Daniel Fittori. And it was hit at the other end of the ground to what that one was hit, and it was a huge hit.
A change of bowling to Sara Pereira.
Right on, right on.
the man who took the catch to dismiss Dave Warner. He's into the attack now, and you'll see a lot more of this as I think 2020 develops too. Lots more bowling changes. Often a bowler will bowl a really good over, might get a wicket, and then he gets taken off.
Yeah, it's all about sort of just trying to change it up, upset the batsman's rhythm. Angelo Matthews. Pereira is primarily a change bowler. He bats as well. Quite a hard hitter down the order, but does get the ball through. He's a skiddy bowler. He's got a skiddy action, but he'll be looking to change his pace as well. And they've also got Angelo Matthews, which they'll swing into action pretty shortly.
Yes, this is a bit of a strategy of theirs. Change them often. Right, now we want to have a look at that six from the batsman's point of view. Just have a look at this. This is another little innovation of ours. Just watch this. There it goes. Down the far end of the ground. Beautifully played. I tell you, there's no better feeling as a batsman than watching it disappear down the ground, especially when you've hit it.
Oh, I can think back to Adam Gilchrist here, the Ashes series 4 years ago, when he smashed Monty Panesar and Matthew Hoggard all down in that area. Some of those were well over 100 metres, I can tell you. 100 off about 57 balls in a test match. Is that out? Oh, no. Just a little shout from the bowler.
You're talking about big sixes. Chris Gayle hit a huge one here at the Wacker last year. Again, hitting it onto the Lily Marsh stand.
So 1 for 21. Now we're into the fifth over here. The run rate's only 4.5. One would have to say that so far it's Sri Lanka.
Yeah, the Sri Lankans have bowled particularly well so far. I think Australia have probably been guilty of almost trying to hit the ball too hard. Apart from that six that we saw and showed you from last over, even Dave Warner's dismissal, trying to go up over the top. And Perth on the Wacker ground is one of those grounds where you just need to time the ball. There's so much pace on the ball as it comes off the pitch that get in the middle of the bat along the ground, it races away for four. That's straight up in the air as well. This time it's Fernando. Can he get hold of it? Oh, brilliant! Absolutely brilliant. Well, misjudged, but he's caught it clean as a whistle.
Oh, boy. I'd given that away. I think Delano Fernando had given it away. And then he stuck his right mitt out, and it stuck in the middle of it. Wonderful catch.
A good bit of bowling again by the Sri Lankans. Michael Clarke opting to go over the top. Fernando looked like he was out of the game completely, but stuck out the claw and holds on to it. Unbelievable catch. He's pretty happy with it too. Australia now 2 for 22 after.
Hi. Did you know that when you call the Quit Line, you can order a free Quit Pack or speak to one of our friendly advisors? Next time you call, why not take up both options? 1-3-QUIT. It's that easy.
Hello again. Just called to say hello.
So David Hussey is the new man for Australia. Australia in a bit of trouble at the moment. Five overs gone, only one left in the power play overs. Two wickets down, run rate's only 4.4. And Muhly to continue. Change of the commentary box. Ian Healy and Mike Slater and Mark Nicholas are with you.
Sri Lanka already looking like a well-oiled machine. Not that there was much oil in the legs of Delano Fernando here. He was backpedalling and struggling. A big fella who pulled it off with one hand, plucked it out of the sky. We haven't been on air long, but that is our moment of the summer.
That's a beauty. It looked like if his balance was slightly different, it would have been the left hand he would have used. It just depended what foot he was on when he was going back. That left, no, I'll take it on the right. And perfectly, a lot would have tried to use both.
Yes, run.
That's nicely punched through the gap. Come back for two. Doesn't matter, heels, when you take it.
That's for sure. They get three there. Nice backward drive from Hussey, but yeah, Dilhara, I guess in the early stages of that, when you're backpedalling, the hammies aren't going for you. He needs big hammies with that big frame he's got. Now he's thinking about the captain. Oh, I'm in trouble here. And then he says, no, hang on. Oh, I've made a huge comeback. Fernando heard the drums and made up for it.
I love the faces on the guys behind. Shock as much as anything else, because they reckon it had gone too. A rebuilding job is needed from Shane Watson and David Hussey. David Hussey's almost the king of the T20 around the world.
Now, this is a period of 2020 that I don't think the players know what to do. Do they rebuild or do they go helter-skelter? Australia's tactics in the World Cup, when they missed out in the final, was to go helter-skelter right from the word go.
Hey!
They weren't big on these rebuilding periods. They backed themselves to get through 20 overs and not get all out. They've got some batting in the shed. What are they going to do tonight?
Well, I don't think there's time in this form to rebuild at all. Heels, and I think that's what the Australians have worked out. This is their most successful year of 2020 cricket. They've got a strike rate of about 70% this year. They've won 70% of the time. They've played about 14, 15 games. And previously, they weren't winning that many. 2 for 27.
Buying a new car is all about comparisons. That's why we're happy for you to compare, to see which car has smart technology.
22 degrees.
Or which one gives you the protection you want. Ford believes you should compare, because we're absolutely confident we've got the car for you. Like this 7-seat Territory TS Limited Edition with leather trim and Bluetooth. From $41,990 drive away. Come in, test drive it, compare it.
Beautiful evening here in Perth. Ideal conditions. Australia won the toss, batting first, finding it difficult against sensible and tidy bowling from the Sri Lankans. Mahela Jayawardena is out there, an old friend of ours and a wonderful player, still going strong. Mahela, have you got us?
Yes. Yes.
Can you hear us?
Yeah.
What a catch. Were you backing your man?
Definitely, he's got big hands. The only thing was the wind, it was taking a bit away from him, but the big boy managed to grab onto that.
Mahela, it must be nice for you to be playing in a side that's involving so many of the younger guys. They seem to be blending in well.
Yeah, I think the shorter version of the game, we've kept introducing a lot of younger players in the last 2-3 years. These guys got a lot of experience as well. There are a couple of guys who's, here for the first time, so they'll enjoy the atmosphere.
And it is a good atmosphere, good crowd in already.
Oh, definitely, brilliant crowd. I mean, 2020 cricket is all about the atmosphere, the crowd, the noise, everything, so enjoying it.
Mahela, Ian Healy, how are you?
Hi, Ian, how are you?
Yeah, good, thank you. How are you enjoying the vice captaincy, not so much the captaincy, and letting Kumar do it all?
Yeah, it's a bit of a demotion, but I'm enjoying it. I don't have much to do, just to make sure that everything runs smoothly, help Kumar out, and make sure the youngsters are, pulling their weight. That's about it.
The other thing, it must be a delight to play Australia without McGrath and Warne for you.
Maybe come off that era.
Good placement from David Hussey. That's very much the way that he plays, and he's quick enough to want to, if not get it, because Watson turned him back. Big thank you to Mahela Jayawardena. Maybe a little more from you later, but it's great to have you back on these shores.
Thanks.
Impressive start from the Sri Lankans. Very, very impressive, particularly in the field. Not always an area we've associated with such sharp work.
And the coach now, Trevor Bayliss, and the coach before, Tom Moody, very much specialising in the fielding side of things. And a direct hit there would have been extremely interesting on the replay.
Now, that is an opportunity that ought to be taken by Murali, and is. So Shane Watson perishes as well. Sri Lanka make the almost perfect start to a T20.
Stuttering the Aussies at the moment. And I think they were thinking, a little bit of that rebuild that you, Ian, was talking about. And here we see a forceful shot from Watson, but he toe-ends it. Therefore, no timing, no distance.
Doesn't really love it. His chance to come back to Australia one more time. It's 3 for 30.
KFC's new Double Crunch Burger Combo is here with two fresh 100% breast fillet chicken crispy strips, creamy pepper mayo, crisp lettuce on a warm sesame seed bun, plus chips and a drink for just $5.95. The best lunch deals are now at KFC, all for just $5.95 each.
Couple of wickets for Tisara Pereira, one for Dilharo Fernando. He's also taken a magical catch. The other two bowlers used the vastly experienced Malinga and Muralitharan. This is Pereira. That is David Hussey on strike because the batsman crossed. Seven gone, it's 3 for 31.
With wide beam LED headlights, ergonomic seating, digital dashboard and push-button ignition system, we have revolutionized the mowing experience with our inspired design. In fact, Victa next generation lawnmowers are so efficient you'll have time to cut your neighbor's grass.
It's the Australian lineup tonight. You've probably heard that a couple of players are missing playing in Shield games, Mitchell Johnson and Michael Hussey. But it's only three players like those two and Sean Tate from the side that in the end lost the final of the World 2020. So it isn't far from what is perceived to be Australia's best team. Here's Cameron White, such a fabulous striker of the ball. He's out there with David Hussey, who has 7 from 9 balls. It's an awkward situation in which Australia find themselves. And Suraj Randeve comes into the attack. Good cricketer, this guy. Oh, got him! Yes! What a way to start. Kumar Sangakkara takes the catch, and he thinks a lot of this young guy. That's why.
Well, he got it spot on. I think all the variations that Sri Lanka have tried tonight have been landing exactly where they need to. The bounce, combined with the cramped nature of a cut shot, brings the edge, and it stays. It stays in the gloves of the skipper. First ball, 1 for. Thank you. 4 for 31.
Chicken feed's all you pay.
The variety store with so much more.
Four bargains every day.
Chicken feed is all you need,
cause a little goes a long, long way.
Chicken feed is all you need, cause a little goes a long, long way.
Wow!
Chicken feed, chicken feed, chicken feed. Bargains with a smile.
Brad Haddin at the crease, and rather sooner than he might have liked to be. 4 for 31, the Australians, from 7 overs and 1 ball. Good, sensible way to get off the mark for Cameron White. The batsman had crossed. Now Haddin will be on strike. You guys were having a chat with Brad Haddin as we see the demise of David Hussey. That's good take with the extra bounce from Kumar Sangakkara.
Yeah, I've been chatting a bit to him through his injury, and I had something similar when I played, and it takes such a long time to get over, and he's tried everything to get back quicker than he's been able to.
Yes.
But finally, Brad Haddin is returning. He's feeling very happy with his progress. He said he's really put it through its paces in the last couple of weeks, and it's holding up. So it's this tennis elbow that has dogged a few cricketers in recent years, actually. It's just the amount they play, the forces they've got to put on that area of their body with the big hitting.
Ow!
What a good delivery. Orthodox off break. We've seen a lot of the unorthodox off break bowlers in the last few years coming out of the subcontinent specifically. Suraj Randeev is more of the orthodox fashion. Gets the seam into a nice position, gets plenty on the ball, and not only does that spin, but it really bounces.
And that's the first sort of ball that he's put out of line, down leg side for Haddon to get a little easy one around the corner. But everything else has been spot on. They're slower balls for the quick bowlers. There's a little drop catch, probably. So if Sri Lanka had a little bit more luck, they would have been five down. Very tough ask, but Cameron White needs to do it again. He's averaging 38. Can he produce 4 for 35?
We were bickering away before we crashed into a farmer's crop.
I was trying to launch my boat.
I was in some kind of joke.
I just didn't see the love in.
You love me, I never claim.
And he gets the same as I did.
What about me?
Amy's Safe Driver Rewards for drivers who don't claim.
Lucky.
Three one-day games to come in the Commonwealth Bank Series, with the Sri Lankans staying with us at Melbourne on Wednesday. That's a day-nighter. And we're up in Sydney on Friday and then Brisbane on Sunday. All opportunities for players. Yes, there is a lot of attention being paid to the start of the Ashes, but these are important games. And rest assured, Sri Lanka are taking them very seriously. They came here earlier than they might have done normally for a short one-day series. I know they've been hit by a little bit of bad weather. They feel quite well prepared.
Yes.
Great conditions at the Wacker to start the Australian summer. But Melbourne, it's all happening there at the moment. They've got their spring carnival. They had Derby Day yesterday. They've got Melbourne Cup on Tuesday. The VB Kangaroos have just started to get one over the Poms for the summer in the Four Nations Rugby League. Just thought I'd add that one there, Nico.
Started, you said.
Yes, and the cricket on Wednesday night down there. So Melbourne enjoying a sporting week, that's for sure. Plenty of tickets available still.
This will be a good game, that league test between England and the Kummels, Papua New Guinea. That'll be close, that.
Nice dig here. Nice dig.
Now look at this. There's just no freebies out here. Sri Lanka have put the ball perfectly. No matter what bowlers, and there's been a lot of changes, there have been no free hits for Australia. They've hit the right length for Perth, and that goes with the preparation, Nico, you were talking about, that they've had, and they've enjoyed themselves over here, and they're executing their plans as well.
That's a long gap in a T20 game. 31 balls without a boundary. Tony Gregg said right at the top of the show, 160 is par. It would be a terrific performance to get to 160 now.
In Australia, having Cameron White out there, they'll be hoping he can pull something off like we saw in Vizag, the Indian Tour. It was a one-day international, of course, so we had plenty more time at the crease, but that was some serious hitting, and we've seen it in this form of the game with White. He can just explode. He'll give himself just a little bit more time. But if he gets on a run, he is so hard to stop. And our little man down in our truck will be measuring the length of his sixes all over the park.
He's up in a spaceship, mate. His satellite.
Well, I didn't know where he was.
Yeah, no, that's high-level stuff. High-level stuff. But he's certainly capable, Cameron White. He's averaging 38 in 2020. That's huge. But 4 for 38, that bench of the Australians are probably hoping someone gets them to 140, maybe. Lot to do.
No!
9 overs, 4 for 38.
Alan's chuckling two ladies.
It could work.
How do we get out of this mess? Wins new 2.5 men Monday.
Hello again. Just called to say hello.
New season Survivor, Tuesday 9:40 on Win.
A cloudless sky in Perth, a pitch with some extra bounce in it, even a hint of spin. talking about Cameron White, and there's no doubt there's something in his body language that is kind of unassuming, and yet you ask players around the world who they really fear, who are the people that can turn one-day matches in the space of half an hour, and he's definitely one.
He is, and why can he be so consistent? I think it's because his technique is pretty good most of the time. I think it's airtight all the time, and I think that's the balance. He's got a technique that holds up. He's got a straightness of bat most of the time, but then he's got an unorthodoxy about him that when he combines it beautifully, therefore he can get consistency. I think he starts his innings in a smart fashion most of the time. If it was a racing start, he'd come out and just pummel from ball one. But he knows now he's got to take just a few balls to get going, massage it round. But if he's there in another couple of overs, then anything can happen. I think that's what everyone wants to see too, because it's electric.
Our first little mistake from any of the Sri Lankans. And a good recovery from the man out at deep mid-off. It's Jai Wardner at extra cover that had the little fumble.
It was a bad miss, that, too, because the fielder had the chance to back up a half volley. Finally, they got a half volley, the Australians. The rest has been there on a really good length, hard to hit. If you over-pitch here in Perth, it's much, much easier. They had the chance to get away with a half volley and didn't. Difficult, I'm sure, both these batsmen looking to go with the spin long over mid-wicket, but they're not sure of the bounce. A top edge is a real prospect. Like going to the right of screen, there's three men protecting that boundary. It would be attractive to lay back and go with the spin, but difficult.
It's 4 for 43.
Hello. Scattered showers tomorrow, mainly about the west and far south. Mostly fine in the main centres, apart from a few showers about Strawn. Temperatures in Hobart between 9 and 17. A degree warmer in the east, with both Swansea and St Helens expecting to reach 18. Launceston should get to 17. Burnie and Devonport 16. And Strawn hoping for a maximum of 15. Enjoy your day tomorrow and good night.
Very hard work out there for the Australians. Sri Lanka doing it well, as Mark Taylor and Tony Gregg come in alongside me.
Yes, they are. Lasit Malinga has got the ball. Only one over, no wicket for five, but a good over it was too, right at the beginning of the innings. Oh, and that's out. That's caught behind. That's a huge nick. Malinga has let that one rip short outside off stump, and the eyes of White lit up.
Kumar Sangakkara is having a terrific night for Sri Lanka as captain. Lost the toss, and about everything else he's done has been perfect. Every time he's changed a bowler, they've got a wicket. This time it's Malinga, and he's removed Cameron White. And as Tony Gregg said, that is a massive wicket for Sri Lanka. Australia now in trouble at 5 for 43.
Come to Bunnings, you can get everything you need.
Lots of brands, lots of products. It's getting easier to shop for the things that you're after in names that you can trust.
Arlec Portable Floodlight, $9.90. 4 litre Cabot's Decking Oil, $52.90. 7-piece sling setting, $288. Gorilla Folding Work Platform, $69. Tough Weed Herbicide Concentrate, $17.98.
Best brands at the lowest prices. Bunnings
Warehouse. Lowest prices are just the beginning.
Well, here's a bright new face, the Australian Steve Smith. Have a look at the bat that he's got there. He's a strong young man. He gets a lot of very positive raps for his ability with the bat. But boy, he is going to be tested here. 5 for 43. Oh, and Malinga gets the edge and it bounces short of slip.
He's hard to pick up. This very low sling is a thing that batsmen talk about and don't really fathom. And therefore, when he bowls in short bursts, you don't have time to work it out, to line it up, so to speak.
I think coupled with that too, Mark, is the fact that he has got that low action and the ball doesn't angle into you like you normally expect a right arm over the wicket bowler to bowl. He's always almost going away from you as a right armer, and as a right-handed batsman, that must be tough.
Well bowled, well bowled, just down the leg side, I think. He, definitely with a new ball, he swings it out. That's the way he goes, and you're right, it's very different. But as soon as it starts to reverse a little bit, then it really does go the other way.
And that really put Mark's point into perspective, because if the angles all suggest the ball's going away from you from the low swing, and then it reverses back into you at the last minute, you see why he has such success.
I think Steve Smith would be agreeing with us at this stage. He missed that by about, 10 centimetres. Fortunately, it just tailed enough to give Paul Rifle, the umpire there, enough doubt that it was going to miss leg stump.
Well, we're bowled and close to the bat, but nothing, no contact that time. Boy, he's nice and revved up. Just around about the 140 kilometres an hour mark. Well, Smith certainly knows he's got a battle on his hands here.
This is supposed to be a batsman's game. It's 2020, isn't it? There's the wicket again. Cameron White, first ball of the over. And the next three to Steve Smith have been beauties. An outside edge that almost carried a first slip, a close LB shout, and then a good bumper that almost got the glove. It's a Sri Lanka, the bowling side, on the attack at the moment.
Well played. That area's covered, though. They've got a sweeper back at square leg. Outfield nice and fast. In comes the throw. They're on their toes, the Sri Lankans. This is a wonderful start for them. They've been working very hard, arrived in Australia early, and they've really got themselves prepared well for this.
Yes, they've used the extra bounce particularly well here. They haven't got carried away by bowling too short. And both Michael Clarke and Shane Watson, looking to hit down the ground, found the extra bounce cost them. It hit high on the bat as they look to hit straight even. Changes of pace work as well. It's 5 for 44.
Life's better connected. The new Ford Fiesta.
Tonight. 11 overs have been bowled, 5 for 44. And the projected total here with, eight runs and over, they'll get to 116. That's not going to be enough, I don't think. They're going to have to do better than that. Yep. Australia need a little gem of an innings from somebody.
Well, if you go back to the last time these two sides met in a 2020 match, was in that World Championship, and Australia were in all sorts of trouble in that game as well. And it was Cameron White and Mike Hussey, after Australia about 5 for 60, got Australia to 5 for 160. And that was the difference in the game. And Australia came out and bowled Sri Lanka out in that game for about 87 in reply. So the game was far from over at this stage, but as you say, Tony, it needs someone, and probably one of these two, to make a big score here.
We know what Haddon's capable of. He's he can do just about anything. Obviously going to just give himself a little bit of time here. He knows the importance now of decent innings from him.
We've seen various bits of magic from Steve Smith since he arrived in the Australian side. The young cricketer of fantastic sense of adventure. We've seen it with the ball, we've seen it in the field, and on occasion with the bat, particularly when he goes offside, he's wonderful at slapping it over extra cover and through square cover. And he seems to have the temperament for the big occasion. He's going to be tested to the limit here because Haddin needs support. Haddin can play strokes like that. Perfect. The straight drive of the night.
And can you believe it? Only the third boundary. Michael Clarke hit a 4-6 in his 16. And that's the only other boundaries we've seen tonight before this one. Lovely cricket shot. authentic straight drive.
Yes, you don't get them better than that. And, of course, we know that he can hit them straight over the sight screen in that manner as well. He's a wonderful straight driver. Hits sixes down the ground with ease. Well, that's well played, too. Threatened to go down the pitch. Just a little late cut for two. 5 for 53.
At Eyelines, we understand value. We offer health fund discounts and no-gap glasses. So come in now and enjoy your health fund benefit before it runs out. Our friendly staff can explain how much you save. Value makes a difference at Eyelines.
Hello. Hello. Just called to see. Hello.
Right, so 5 for 53. 12 overs have been bowled. They'll get a single there. They might look for a second. Yes, coming back for two. Right, you've never seen a classic Aussie road trip like this one. Catch the Top Gear boys on a caravan adventure. Plus special guest Shane Warne. I can't see him in a caravan. Goes for a very fast spin. All the new Top Gear, it's all new Top Gear Australia, Tuesday at 7:30. Warney in a caravan.
Do they make a five-star caravan with room service?
The shot. Goes at, very good shot. They'll get one.
That goes at 220.
Haddon 11, Smith 6. Sri Lanka really bowling very well, fielding well too. Clark in charge here. Opened the batting today. Out for 16.
Already, you just sense that these two are turning it round slightly. They've only added some 14 for this wicket. But all of a sudden, there's been a boundary and there's more urgency in the running between wickets. We saw a really good two to start this over where the ball was just butted on the leg side. And they ran quickly. I just sense that this might be the opportunity Australia need to turn the momentum in their favour.
Oh, that's a good shot, is it? Yes, it's wide of the fieldsman down there, and it's gone all the way. All the way for six. Well, now that's quite a long boundary down there.
That's the magic that we're hoping for. He's a modern cricketer. He gets his left side out of the way and he can hit it anywhere he wants between there and right round to sort of extra coverish.
Back for the second. They thought about it. That first six was 97 metres, the one straight down the ground. Beautiful shot by Michael Clark. This one is played in the direction of mid-wicket. Have a look at this, from just outside off stump.
And that one has only just cleared the rope out there, but it's probably just as big, because it certainly is a lot wider at this ground than it is straight down the ground. That's a good hit.
It's over the top of backward point. They'll come back for the second. Well, they're starting to open their shoulders now. This run rate is starting to improve. Best over of the innings, it's 5 for 6.
You know that if you come into Bunnings, you can get all the top brands at the lowest prices and know that you're still getting good quality, even though you're paying less.
Stanley 20-piece screwdriver set, $29.94. Dirt Devil vacuum, $129. Pool or garden fencing, $99. Pack of three Sellies liquid nails, $11.50. If you happen to find a cheaper price on a stocked item, we'll beat it by 10%.
Check out our latest catalogue online. Bunnings
Warehouse. Lowest prices are just the beginning.
Well, that's the Australian batting card. They won the toss, decided to bat first. Really good fast pitch here, the normal whacker pitch. lovely outfield, but unfortunately they just couldn't get going. And one of the strategies that the Sri Lankas have used out there has been to continue to change their bowlers. Moodley was on very, very early. Another change being made now. He's back into the attack. Start of his third over.
This will be interesting. Stephen Smith on striker. Leg spin bowler himself, likes to hit the ball hard. Sorry, he's at the non-striker's end. Haddon on strike at the moment. That'll be a wide. It'll be interesting to see how Steve Smith plays Murali Dhuran. He likes to hit the ball. And yet Murali Dhuran, plenty of experience in all forms of the game. Not the easiest man to hit over the top.
Well, he's got a bit of edge on that, I think. And it's going to go all the way. Vital runs, yep, four signalled.
Well, it's not where he intended this to go, Brad Haddon. But if he can get the ball straight, on this occasion it was almost straight behind him. The boundaries are much shorter, straight down the ground, and they are quick. The outfield's extremely quick. That was a bottom edge and it ran away.
He sent him back, and that's... Oh, it's a bad throw. It was an underarm that time, but it was far too wide of the stumps. Sangakkara had to go a long way to drag it back.
It's the first little period in the game where one or two things have gone the Australians' way. A direct hit would have done for Haddon. There was the little moment the ball before, the under edge. There was the skied thing over backward point from Steve Smith. Suddenly it's 5 for 72 and Australia are back in it.
Yeah, you reckon with six overs after this that still a chance of 130? 10 and over from here on in.
Wait.
Just get the feeling with Australian bowling side and Sri Lanka, who don't necessarily play their best cricket on bouncy pitches. Australia will feel they're a good chance if they can post, 120 plus, 130 or 140, they'll feel they're right in the game.
You are an optimist.
There we go again, straight down the ground. Beautiful shot by Haddon. Boy, he's playing that straight drive as well as he's ever played it.
That's why, Mark, because look at that for a shot. Straight down the ground. One beats the keeper the other way and now straight over his head.
Remember that fabulous innings here against South Africa in the Test match? 96, I think he got. And he just couldn't resist trying to make 100 with a six. He got caught at mid-on. He can strike him as well as anybody. It's 5 for 76.
Buying a new car is all about comparisons. That's why we're happy for you to compare. To see which car has smart technology.
22 degrees.
Or which one gives you the protection you want. Ford believes you should compare, because we're absolutely confident we've got the car for you. Like this 7-seat Territory TS Limited Edition with leather trim and Bluetooth from $41,990 drive away. Come in, test drive it, compare it.
So 5 for 76. So Delara Fernando, who's already made a useful contribution with a ball and an absolutely magnificent contribution, that catch of his to get rid of Michael Clark. Very nicely played again, well fielded too. Just the single. Just have a look at this catch. Michael Clark had got himself to 16, just started to get going. And then this is what happened. Back he went, didn't look as if he was going to get anywhere near it. And... unbelievable.
At what stage, Tony, do you reckon he thought he had that catch?
Well, I don't think he thought he ever had it. neither did that bloke behind. Did you see the look on that Aussie's face?
Yes, it wasn't until the ball lodged straight in the middle of that right hand that I think Dilhara Fernando thought, I've got this. He didn't look comfortable. He put the right hand up and he thought, oh no, I'll get two. Well, no, I won't. I've totally misjudged it, but that'll do.
He was smiling, that bloke in the grey. And Dilhara Fernando soon wiped the smile of his face. Good shot. That's going way over the top. That's into the crowd. Is it just short? Lovely six. The Aussies now are starting to get it together.
Here comes Haddon. He is as good a striker of the cricket ball as there is in world cricket when he gets going. Because he hits a lot by that, fairly straight. It's a good full face of the bat on that. Just goes with the angle.
He was talking to Michael Slater and Ian Healy just before play, and I was listening in, and he just says this elbow is sorted, finally. The left elbow problem he's had for so long. He said it's the best it's been for as long as I can remember.
39 of the last 20 balls. Oh, that one was heading to the square leg boundary as well. Just didn't quite manage to latch onto it. That last six. Have a look at it on Eagle Eye. Here she goes. And 89 metres. Big hit.
Is Michael Clark will want to see that. He'll say, Brad, 8 metres short of where I hit mine.
That's a nick, is it? Oh, no, it's not. He must have flicked the turf. Certainly a noise, a very clonky noise through my headset on that occasion.
Well, I agree. I thought there was a little bit of the bat brushing the turf, but also a sort of woodier sound that went with it.
I think it gives us an idea of how hard that pitch is out there. For 83 now, Fernando, two to go this over.
Oh, yeah.
Certainly mixing it up.
He's mixed up very well, Dilhara Fernando. I get the feeling watching Haddon over those last couple of deliveries after he hit the big six, he was waiting for the slower ball. I reckon he felt there was a slower ball on its way, but Fernando has held three balls at around about 140 Ks and has fooled Haddon. So after staying the over well with a one and then a six, a couple of dot balls and a single, hasn't been as bad an over for Sri Lanka as it may have been.
Oh, well played again. Running backwards and flicking it away on the onside. That takes the score to 5 for 85.
Come to Bunnings, you can get everything you need.
Lots of brands, lots of products. It's getting easier to shop for the things that you're after in names that you can trust.
Arlec Portable Floodlight, $9.90. 4 litre Cabot's Decking Oil, $52.90. 7-piece sling setting, $288. Gorilla Folding Work Platform, $69. Tough Weed Herbicide Concentrate, $17.98.
Best brands at the lowest prices.
Bunnings Warehouse. Lowest prices are just the beginning.
Right, the Australians making a comeback here, 5 for 85. Michael Slater is moving into position with Tom Moody and Ian Healy.
Thanks, Craigie. Five huge overs for the Aussies, equally for Sri Lanka as well, if they can get Hastings in, Mackay, Siddle. Not a lot of experience there in the Australian batting to come. In fact, they'll be into the tail at John Hastings all-rounder. We see Steve Smith advancing. A lot of energy in this partnership now. It's worth 43. And Haddon is just starting to unleash.
It's a good opportunity for Brad Haddon, who's been out of action in the Australian team for some time through the various injuries he's had. But he's showing some fine form here, resurrecting the Australian innings.
He's taking that to the onside. One bounce to the man just behind square in the deep. I thought he'd found the gap there. I thought he probably felt that as well. Morley, at the best of times, hard to get away. He's been a little expensive this evening. Smith comes down. Outside edge, no run. A lot happening out there for nothing, Hills.
Smith's not sure what to do. I wonder if this was a deucer and that's why he outside edged it. He thought he had it covered easily, looking to take him down the ground and then missed it.
Oh, this is an inside edge. It's going to race away. They need the boundary, Australia. They get one. A sigh of relief. Not too attractive, though.
Well, Kumar Sangakkara, I think he can't do much about that. He's got his man at 45. His vice-captain, Mahela Jayawardena, pretty fine, but not fine enough for this one to get away. And when you hit it straight here at the Wacker, whether it's behind the wicket or in front, it's the quickest way to the boundary.
Take the single there. One ball remaining for Murali's over, and that'll be the end of his spell. This is a terrific partnership, exactly what the Aussies needed. And it's young Steve Smith who's teamed up with his New South Wales teammate in Brad Haddon. Both terrific hitters.
And that's the 50 for the two. We talk about the top order players, but Smith has come in from nowhere into this side, and he's 22 from 17 in conjunction with Haddon, 31. Four overs, big overs to go.
What I like about both of them is they're different. That's probably troubling the Sri Lankan bowlers in that Haddon, he'll hit his bigger shots down the ground. He's very orthodox and controlled a lot of the time. He'll hoik the blue lines to the onside there. That's Haddon seeing it so well. But Steve Smith is a little unorthodox. He's a strong striker of the ball, but he goes to different parts, moods.
Yeah, look, the other thing about Steve Smith is the Sri Lankans wouldn't have seen him before. Brad Haddon certainly has seen a lot of him as a teammate from New South Wales, but the Sri Lankans wouldn't have seen a lot of him. He's been very effective in domestic cricket here in Australia, and hence his promotion in the Australian team. But he does hit the ball well, and he does hit the ball all round the ground.
Lasith Malinga coming in for his third spell. That's 20-20. Third over, third spell. He's been used perfectly.
How different is this game? He's gone for the big Yorker. Oh, good fielding. Is that our catcher, Fernando?
Yeah, he's the one with the sticky paw. But just picking up on what Hill said about Malinga, what you can guarantee is that he'll always bowl at the end of the innings. In world cricket, there's very few better than him bowling at the death. He gets the ball right up into that block hole. He's got good change of pace and a swift bouncer.
And great hair. Look at that hair. Once again, he brings the tips to Australia. Did you encourage that, Moods, when you were coaching them?
I think it's very important to express yourself. And Malinga on this occasion is doing it beautifully. And you'll probably see in the crowd tonight a few people wearing the Malinga wig. It tends to follow him all around the world.
Hills, you've tried that style before.
Yes, yes, there's one, there's one. Two varieties of it. Dangerous if he's going to get his full toss down leg here. Fine legs up.
Oh, it's clever. It's clever. The courage to play this sort of shot, and we see it more and more. The modern-day cricketer just stepping across, sweeping the fast bowler.
Yeah, it's called the ramp, and you need to be brave. There's no question. And that was played so well because Haddon kept very still. And, Smith kept very still, and it's created a field change here. Kumar Sangakkara's bringing mid-off up and dropping the fine leg back.
Young Steve Smith, he's got a great attitude to the game, and I was reading Stephen O'Keefe, who's part of this squad and going great guns for New South Wales, winning opportunity in the squad. He's saying that as a 25-year-old, Steve Smith being younger, that he's infectious with his attitude, Smith. He just loves the game. He's happy-go-lucky, trains hard, but plays with a smile on his face all the time and quite relaxed. And that's great in any team. And I think he's been around this Aussie side enough that they can see that spirit and I think we're seeing it on display here.
Well, what about that last shot? I was worried about the ball slanting down leg side, but he's done it from outside off. So the shot was on, but he's had to manufacture something, and as Mood said, you need some courage. That could top edge and get caught or up under your helmet. It's coming at 140 km. You need to be careful. He was good.
It's a slow ball from Malinga, and they'll be happy with the single at this stage, Sri Lanka. They want to break this partnership. They want to see Hastings out there.
Great bowling. Great bowling. He follows up his fast sliders with really accurate, well-pitched slower balls. So once again, no freebies for the Aussies.
It's very hard for a batsman to get set when you're looking for the boundaries, when you're changing the pace, and particularly the extremer pace we're talking about that Malinga's delivering it at.
Well, now, come on, last ball.
Oh, he lay back to go big. It's another single. Well bowled, Malinga. 17 gone. 5 for 103.
KFC's new Double Crunch Burger Combo is here with two fresh 100% breast fillet chicken crispy strips, creamy pepper mayo, crisp lettuce on a warm sesame seed bun, plus chips and a drink for just $5.95. The best lunch deals are now at KFC, all for just $5.95 each. Can't beat that beast.
59 in the last six for the Australians. That's got them to 5 for 103. They're going to need another 50 at least, which is tough going in three overs, I must say, but that's what we can expect in T20. Change in the bowling, and straight away Met down the ground. Just not timed, so they'll come back for two.
I thought he had it as well. I thought he'd really got that out of the screws. But again, good bowling. He had to wait for it. It wasn't right up there in the slot. He knew he was advancing at him. He made him wait and hit it on the up, creating the miss hit. Sort of miss hit.
Well, I thought it was going to be six. Now he's gone the reverse. This one's a boundary. Gee, that's a good shot. Outstanding. Young Steve Smith.
This is what we see young players do these days. And great improvisation here. Reverse sweeping, hitting it clean as a whistle. Finding the boundary.
Good start. 2 and 4 to the Australians. And now out. Yeah, well bowled. Randy, he just slowed that one up, didn't he? And it created the mistake from Steve Smith, who came down and pretty well swung himself off his feet.
Well, he was due to advance. He'd gone advance, reverse sweep, third ball again. Came at the bowler. He held his nerve, made him wait again. Look at that bounce. Shoulder height to Sangakkara. Quick enough to get him off. And Smith departs a magnificent 34 from 23. 2.5 overs to go. 109 the Aussies.
You won't believe who gets caught. Red-handed.
That's not what it looks like.
New The Mentalist, Monday.
If you're looking to invest or buy a new home, yes is a beautiful word. Get the advantage you need. Apply for pre-approval. Talk to a MyState financial home loan expert today.
Travel the world with Getaway, Thursday.
John Hastings, the Victorian, should I say, New South Welshman, went to Victoria and now playing for Australia. Indeed, bowling a beautiful delivery, having gone for two down the ground, then a reverse sweep four. It was a toppy, it looked like, but he slowed it up beautifully through the air.
Yeah, what Randiv is getting is bounce, and what he is delivering is a lot of top spinners. And it's very hard to hit the ball clean when you're getting that bounce.
Work into the onside. There's a man under it, and he's going to take it. So all of a sudden, capitulation again for the Australians. They're in trouble, 7 for 110. It's the dangerous had and gone. And Matthews in the deep takes it comfortably.
The Australians have resisted this shot all afternoon. But at this stage of the innings, it had to be played and not played perfectly. Matthews perfectly positioned. Randiv put the ball right where it needed to, so Brad Haddin couldn't get it in the middle. So now Haddon gone for 35. That was just off 30 balls.
It's a longer boundary out there, so Haddon Wiley probably timed that pretty well, just didn't get enough elevation. He's probably thinking to himself, I should have just gone for the full Monty. I tried to time it into the onside instead of really trying to smash it.
Yeah, I think the real issue is the length of the boundary out there, square of the wicket. You know, if you are looking for the maximum, if you're looking for the big six, you're better off going straight. And he does hit the ball well straight.
Or smash it in the gap, flat and fast, through square leg and take the gap on rather than the man. I'm sure the gap was in his mind, but didn't get it right. Mackay.
Oi! And we have a forward defence to finish the run deep over. 3 for 25 after four. Brilliantly bowled.
Alan's got a new girlfriend.
Oh, boy.
A new home.
Isn't this nice? Eating together as a family?
Everything is perfect. Until his ex turns up.
Now what?
Who will he choose? Wins new 2.5 men. Monday, 7:30.
How far will a classic Aussie road trip go before it turns bad? Plus, the Chaser Boys. New Top Gear Australia, Tuesday.
There's a new partnership requiring to go hard in the remaining 12 deliveries. John Wayne Hastings, the Duke, in with Clint Mackay. That one, he charges in Malinga. And it's been called a wide, well, maybe a little harsh.
Harsh, all right. I thought it was perfectly pitched. Great idea. Probably expecting something sliding in at the feet and get one whizzing past the nose.
It's beautifully bowled. Yeah, a bit tough, that one. And Sri Lankans have done their homework. Hastings can cause a bit of damage if you get the ball up there. But if you bowl short, he's not as strong on the square of the wicket shots.
Hastings, he's a big unit. And he did well to keep that one out. Malinga is really zoning in. The short one now, the full one. I think you can comfortably think you're going to get another few Yorkers or attempted Yorkers at least. So what do you try and do? I suppose you're just trying to work with it because he angles into the stumps, work it a bit to the onside.
The first thing you've got to consider is that both of these guys wouldn't have faced anything like this. You know, Malinga bowling, slinging action, 140 plus with a great slower ball. They wouldn't have seen anything like this because traditionally bowlers bowl over the top. So really they've got to have a short back lift and get bat on ball.
And if you can get it over the pickets. Not one of those chips into the outfield that you used to play, Heels. Something with a bit of wood on it.
No worry, they'd take a chip now. Don't worry about that. If you get bat on ball, it needs to be into a gap too. That's the next step, the next level of thinking. Get your eye in and then try to find a gap. And rotated around. They've brought in the offside field, so there's nothing easy on the, as we look at that, the left of screen.
Big gap over mid wicket. And that's going to be wide down the leg side. No room for error there. And while it's not far from hitting the leg peg, to be honest with you, it's always going to be called wide. So that's a bonus for the Aussies. Sri Lanka will fancy their run chase already. They've done well in the field. It's not over. Wickets will stall the Australians even further.
Well, 10 balls to survive and try to build. 125, maybe 130. Oh, that's a bit different.
See a lot of different in this game, don't we? Particularly from the tail enders. Out there trying to eke, let's say, another 20 to 30 runs.
Yeah, Mackay looking to take on the pull shot here. And he's quite glad that hit the willow and not him.
Yeah, first thing, I guess, get the back lift low, as you say. Then look for the flight of the ball. Is it going to be feet or is it going to be body? And then try to come up with a response.
And he's got the slow ball. There's a single. As he hits, that would have been out, run out, without a doubt. And it's something that we've noticed. They haven't hit the stumps as they would have liked today, Sri Lanka. But they've been pretty good in the field. Haven't missed too many opportunities when it's been in the air.
That's Chamara Kapalgetero, who's one of the better fielders. He and Dilshan in the picture there are very good infielders and outfielders for that matter. So both of them missed the stumps tonight.
Tail end is really struggling with the variation that he's got, and he's mixing it up better than I've seen. I reckon he used to be a little bit one pace, didn't he, and tried the similar thing. But the slinginess of his action, very hard, as you mentioned, Tom. They've not faced this before, so extremely difficult to come out. The expectation is you're trying to hit the boundaries,
and it's even harder if you're moving. So if you're backing away and your head's moving, you lose your shape as a batsman. It's even harder to hit. But Malinga's had a lot of experience now. He's had three IPLs where he's developed his skills.
There's another wide, so the bonus comes again. Just trying a little bit too much at 118.8 kilometres an hour. He's normally up there around 140 at least.
Yeah, it's not only just the slinginess of his action, it's the round arm nature of it as well. That one was, I think he tried to get it up a little bit higher and lost control. But a round arm slinger, as a batsman, you'd swear it was going to go way out to the left. And he hooks it around at pace with pretty good effect.
There's plenty of balls in this over, but not enough boundaries from Australia's point of view.
Nicely played. It should run away. It's perfectly in the gap. There'll be an effort and a good effort, but just couldn't quite haul it in. We've got an over remaining. Australia, 7 for 120.
You won't believe who gets caught.
Stop!
Red-handed.
That's not what it looks like.
New The Mentalist, Monday.
If you're looking to invest or buy a new home, yes is a beautiful word. Get the advantage you need. Apply for pre-approval. Talk to a MyState financial home loan expert today.
New season survivor, Tuesday 9:40 on Win. Day.
Doesn't read too well for the Australians. 2-16, 4-7-8. That really hurts when your middle order's not got any potency about it. 35 and 34. There was a resurrection there. Terrific partnership, Haddon and Smith. And now Hastings and Mackay have got to try and get through the last six deliveries from Fernando in explosive fashion. There are three wickets still in the bank. And, well, they just don't want to waste the ball, do they? They want to try and get two minimum, I'd say, and try and find the boundary a couple of times this over.
Yeah, look, these certainly the pair that has to do the work. But, again, they've got to deal with the pace of Fernando, but also the change of pace that Fernando's got. He also has got a very good slow ball, a different style of slow ball than Malinga. He's got a split finger slow ball against the off-spinning slow ball. So he'll be looking to mix it up.
You've got all the men out the fence, four men in the circle. Looks like there's plenty of gaps, but it'll be difficult to find them. It's a handy start. There'll be two there. Back on the throw. There was a slight hesitation. The dive will get them home.
That's good. They're on the way to 135, maybe. And very, very obvious the intention. Open up that front side by Hastings and slash wherever you can. If he bowls into my zone, I'll hit him over leg. If it's wide of off, I can skew it over the offside and fight my way for two.
Well, the options for Fernando, if the batsman is giving room at the crease and going to leg, is to bowl full pitch wide of that off stump and look for the dot ball.
Recontrolled down to third man. It's not like the shot you'd expect to see in the 20th and final over of an innings, is it? It's the little run down there.
No, this has worked out beautifully for Sri Lanka. All their best three bowlers were the last three employed at a time where they need economy. Dilhara's three overs up to this over had cost 16. And Malinga was about 16 or 17 with one over to go. And Randeev was the same as well. So three for 25 for Randeev. Perfect for the offie. Dilhara to back him up. Last over.
Nicely struck. It'll only be one. Again, we see those short, straight boundaries into play, allowing the man in the deep to get there quickly and cut down the second. If that had gone square, every chance the batsman would have come back for two. I think from Mackay it was the right idea, trying to hit straight back towards the sight screen. It's a difficult task though for the tail ender.
Well, this total just has to be enough. It's whatever they get, whether it's 130, 135, it has to be enough. The bowlers have got to work towards that. No excuses now.
It's gone fine enough. It'll be two bounces. One bounce, four. And that'll work. The outside edge. The inside edge. It doesn't matter. If it goes to the boundary, the Aussie supporters will cheer it on.
They're scared to follow him up. Hastings backed away a little bit. Opened up and Dilhara went away outside off, which brought the edge. Maybe following him in at the base of middle could have been an option. But rarely have they got it wrong.
Yeah, he's obviously concerned about having his fine leg up, not, you know, hence him not following the batsman as he's backing away.
Just chased him there, and there'll be another boundary, two in a row. Good start.
Well, that's the problem. If you follow him and you don't have your fine leg back, you're in trouble. So another boundary to the leg side. Valuable runs for the Australian team. Now on 132. Dilhara Fernando's got some thinking to do to finish off this over.
Yeah, looking to cramp him, but you could cramp him by bowling on leg stump. That was about a metre outside leg stump. That was a poor ball. That was a poor ball. The one before, a metre outside off. This one, a metre outside leg. And Hastings on fire. 14 from 7.
It just seems like he's not locked into what he's trying to achieve with that delivery. And he followed the batsman too much. Hastings, this is powerful hitting. Inventive. And that's why he was Bradman Young Player of the Year last year. They come back for two. And Sangakkara, he thinks he's got him. And it probably is going to be run out. 7 for 133, Australia. We have a relatively quick change over here. Australia have underdone it with the runs, so it gives Sri Lanka a fantastic opportunity to chase it down. But you feel with the extra pace and bounce in the pitch tonight, that's going to help the Australian bowlers as well. But as expected, the Sri Lankans are elated with their performance out there, and so they should be.
Could quite possibly have been better, even. I think this fight back by the Aussies have got them in the contest anyway. Still waiting for the third umpire to say yes, it's out. Hastings has run off, 15 from 8 balls. He's run off. He's got to get the bowling wheels on and get loose for his new job. But Sangakkara pretty happy, but there's still work to be done. The Australians can fire up on this Sri Lankan top order and cause all sorts of havoc if they get it right.
I just think what Manus can do out there, he's got a very quick delivery, isn't he? His left arm, it really gets him down there. Siddle's enthused, he's back in the side. Clint Mackay knows what the pitch is playing like. He was just out there batting. And Mark Taylor is down there to conduct a couple of interviews for us.
Yeah, thank you, Michael Slater. I've got Australia's, well, all-rounder, leg-spinning all-rounder, Steve Smith with me. 8 for 133. Is that enough?
Hopefully. We'll have to bowl well. There's a bit of pace in the wicket, so hopefully our two debutants, Clint and Big Hayso, can come out and bowl fast and take a few early ones.
And what about you, mate? Nice to be back in Australia's colours again. You seem to be enjoying yourself out there.
Yeah, it's good to be back playing again. It's been a little while since I've played a game, so no, it's good to be back out here and make a little contribution.
And what about the pitch out there? What was it playing like? You seem to enjoy it. There's a couple of nice boundaries here.
Yeah, no, it was coming on pretty well. I was lucky enough to get a couple away, so it was good.
And what about the Sri Lankan bowling? They seem to make some really good changes, and they used a very good change of pace against your batsman.
Yeah, their slower balls are quite hard to pick up. Fernando and Malinga, their slower balls are pretty tough, and they're coming onto the bat pretty well. And their spinners seem to bowl well as well, changing their pace and mixing their links up. So it was quite tough to get away.
And Steve, how do you see your game? Do you see yourself as a bowler who bats in this game, or a batsman who bowls?
At the moment, probably getting picked more of as a bowler. So I've been working pretty hard on my bowling in the nets, and every opportunity I get to come out and play for Australia, I've got to put my best foot forward in that form of the game, I guess. So hopefully down the track I'll become a genuine all-rounder, you know, so I'm working pretty hard at that.
Well, mate, you've got a big job tonight. You've got to get some wickets for Australia, but thanks for your time. Now, Australia's leg spin bowler, Steve Smith. Now, stay right with us. After the break, we're going to have Mark Nicholas going to join me, and we're going to recap the Australian innings. We'll also have Justin Langer, the Australian batting coach, to review the Ashes. See you shortly.
That Mackay, very accurate. You know he's going to get the ball in the right area. Two slips. It's wide of off miss hit by Jay Wardner. So if these two stay in for any length of time, Sri Lanka win the match. So Australia just have to break through before the score is, well, I don't know, 30, 40, and they have to get a roll on somehow.
Yeah, and so a good start too. This field having two slips in there, it's, you know, in 2020 cricket, it's one slip for a while and then all of a sudden the slip disappears in no time as it did when the Sri Lankans were bowling. But Clark is, I think, forced to have a couple in there for the nick.
Oh, inside edge. A little off-cutter through to the gloves of Haddon. There's been a lot of handshaking, back patting, encouragement in the huddle for Australia. Clint Mackay on debut for Australia. His first two, okay.
They've got to try and get the enthusiasm up heels at the moment. Australia are losing everything. They've had a treacherous few months. India was disappointing for them. They're in England, that neutral series against Pakistan, then the one day is to follow.
Outside edge this time. Full and swinging away.
Well, I think we know what the intent here is of Jai Wardner. He's going to absolutely go at everything. He's normally a batsman who you associate with getting a few singles early on and feeling his way a little bit. But in 2020 cricket, he's obviously decided that he's going to do a Dilshan. Go for everything.
Well, the Australians didn't cope at all well with pace and bounce and good slow balls at the top of the order. Jaya Wardner certainly hasn't started convincingly. So these Perth conditions really don't suit their play traditionally. They're not used to the ball bouncing and seaming away and back in as often as it does here. But this is their first chance with an inexperienced opponent.
Jay Wardner's got the fastest 100 for Sri Lanka in 2020 cricket. So he can be very explosive. But I think the advantage of chasing a target of 134 is that you can be a bit more correct. Technically, there's a bonus for them. They're off the mark with a wide. But already Dilshan and Jay Wardner know that they can just bring it back a little bit, be a little bit more technically correct. So that's the advantage of knowing what you're chasing. But just in that stat I said, he's got the quickest 100 in 2020 cricket in the Sri Lankan side. There hasn't been an Australian scorer at 2020 international 100 yet.
And it's followed up and supported well by Dilshan and Sangakkara as well. But he's certainly not looking to pull it back, Slats, is he? He's looking to blaze with all guns against Mackay. Jay Wardner, he's played two or three airy, fairy cover drives and attempts, and it's all on.
Very relaxed they are. I went and had a curry with them the other night over in Sydney. And
did you?
Yep. And wives, girlfriends, welcome on the tour. Unlike the England lot, they've banned them. No wives, no girlfriends, not only for the first two test matches.
Only for a couple of weeks. Well, the wags will be here before you know it. But they've got their partners here, the Sri Lankans. It's a short tour as well.
Oh, absolutely, yeah. They're very relaxed.
He's all quickly into their camp, though, Greggy. Oh, another one. They need an edge, the Aussies. I guess you picked up the tab as well. One over, none for two.
Get into cricket with BetterSport. You can even bet after the game has started. Just call 13Better. That's 13-23-82. Or for more odds, visit the website or drop into your local tote. BetterSport, a better way to bet.
Give your home a gift this holiday season. Decorama Christmas Freemake is available now. Breathe new life into your favourite spaces. Create your style with curtains at Decorama this Christmas. What's your style?
Decorama.
Strong top order, middle order unknown. Bowlers are just that, not great with the bat. So Australia have to get through to number four minimum quite quickly. Dirk Nannis is the bowler that's coming on to support the work of Clint Mackay's first over. None for two. Left-hander, change of angle, good pace, generally good accuracy. That one squirted and brilliantly saved. Warner the man.
Oh, that's wonderful fielding. That really is beautiful. We've seen a bit of it. We saw the Sri Lankans do a bit of this. But have a look at this. He's taken off. Never looked like doing anything other than covering it, did he?
And that's where the field set. You see those two men, very square. There's a gap to the right of David Warner through the covers. And that's going to tempt Jay Wardner into some sort of drive in the hope of an edge to the two slips. Nannis goes across him and it is smashed. No chasing that down.
Just waited for that. It's good pace and he's used every bit of the 144 kilometres. He just rocks back just slightly. He was just in this beautiful still position, Jay Wardner, helped it on its way. That is a perfect shot here at the Wacker. And it just takes Gully out of play because you're just over the top of that backward point Gully area.
Angle's one thing, but length has to be right. No easy cut shots, that's good. He's still able to turn the strike over and pick up one.
Yes, you're right about that, the elegance of that shot. He did open the face a little bit. He tried purposely to get it over the infield. I think that's got to be part of the strategy in 2020 cricket. I think the good players of over-the-top shots early on in the innings are going to be the most devastating. Only two fields when allowed back. If you can get it up in the air and over that infield, that's where you get the boundaries.
And that's a lot easier to do if you're given width. If you're having to do it from a cramped ball at the body, it's much harder in Perth. The top edge is on and the miss hit. Sri Lanka got it right in their innings and they've got it right with the bat now.
This is Dilshan off the strike with a lovely clip into the onside. So Nannis is just straying a little bit. He's overcorrected here. He's gone too wide. Now he's gone too straight and dragged it to the leg stump. And all that was required was a flick to the onside. You think of the first two dismissals of the Aussie batsmen, the openers, they were straightish deliveries that they tried to pump down the ground and miscued them, skying them. Easy catch. Well, I shouldn't say easy catches. Fernandez was a beauty, wasn't it? Might have made it look a little harder.
So I think the other thing that Sri Lanka did very well was they actually bowled to their field. They had a stacked offside field and bowled outside that off stump. That was very well taken by Haddon.
Let's have a look and see if he got away with one here. Nannis. Oh, geez, he was given that little bit of leniency there. Overhead height, probably. They said no, and Haddon had his hands full. Full stretch, right hand. Just under seven and over required. They're on target. And there's another one. It's the cover gap that's been left in the hope of an edge. But the results are four. 13 off the second over.
KFC's new Double Crunch Burger Combo is here with two fresh 100% breast fillet chicken crispy strips, creamy pepper mayo, crisp lettuce on a warm sesame seed bun, plus chips and a drink for just $5.95. The best lunch deals are now at KFC, all for just $5.95 each. Can't beat that beast.
It's all about wickets. Mackay getting smashed again. Don't worry about the gap. I'll go over the man.
Greggy, this is exactly what you were talking about. There's a comfort, isn't there, in hitting over the top. Look, he's pierced the gap. He's found that extra cover region. But it was the room he gave himself, and then he hits through the line over the top.
Yeah, he did, right? Well, I mean, you and Heels both know all about that. Both of you used to do it on a regular basis.
In the backyard, maybe. That one's a little wider. It is smashed even more aggressively and effectively. Along the ground, the fielder had no chance.
Oh, I don't know about that. I didn't think it was that far away from him. I know it was hit hard. I'd like to see that from a reverse angle. Let's see how far away. It smashed beautifully away. Oh, no, you're right.
Only about 5 metres, Ricky.
But even so, I thought it was, you know, he'd just given up. It only had to be 2 metres to the right of him and he didn't have a chance. That is stroke play. Mackay goes short. The top edge is on. The fielder's not quite able to get to it.
Nana's there trying to make amends for a couple of loose deliveries. Just couldn't quite get there. And now, Michael Clark, what are you doing? Are you keeping two slips in there? We've only allowed 2 men outside the circle. He's got his 2 catches, first and second slip. They're remaining.
I think the Sri Lankans have got an appointment at the local curry house this evening.
Are you going?
He has to. He's got, got to get the bill back.
Although there might be confusion. I know England are in town. The steak and kidney pie could be on.
Yes, they're in town all right, and they're in a good frame of mind as well. This is going to be an interesting summer. I want you guys to dip it all. Keep your peckers up, won't you?
Something like that.
He's waiting for, to hear what you'd say there. We'll try, Greggy.
Oh, that's the top edge. That's when it becomes difficult. It's also when you have to depart. Oh, it was a free hit. Do you believe that? We were talking about other things, Tony.
He's gone the big one, as you're going to on the free hit. And the token catch. At least it didn't go anywhere near that boundary rope for the Australians. Current run rate, 9.75.
There's work to do again for Nannis. So the Australians not getting it right. They're being very one-paced. They're being full and short and wide and straight. And the Sri Lankans are loving it.
Yes, they'll all be up in Colombo and Trincomalee and down in Gaul. They'll be loving every moment of this. And there'll be plenty of Sri Lankans, a lot of them live in this country, looking forward to the match in Melbourne. Game in Sydney as well as Brisbane, so they've got themselves off to a great start here. No wicket for 27.
Tasplate this Christmas, and we'll give you a $50 gift voucher to put under the tree. My style, my plate. Tasplates.com.
Nine and over, the Australians don't need to see that. They've erred everywhere. So when they tried to go across the right-hander, it was just a little bit too wide, a little bit too short. Nannis's first over went for 13. That's why Siddle is on. On from a long layoff. Injuries, I'm sure he's fresh and rearing to go. Let's see if he can get a wicket first up.
Yeah, I think a smart move. Keep the changes coming. Do what the Sri Lankans did. See if they can get a wicket by changing the bowlers. Yeah, still 2 slips in position, though. He's obviously got to keep that attacking feel going.
Oh, that's nothing wrong with that delivery. But I tell you what, it's a world-class shot.
My word, it is. It was just short of a good length. Dave Warden has hit that on the up. Gave himself room again to open up the offside. We've seen it a couple of times. He'll just step back slightly. How he was able to impart that much power is beyond me. That is beautifully timed.
Yes, he's a wonderful timer of the ball. He did right. Tremendous stroke maker, playing a very different role here to the normal elegant role that he plays. He's blasting it.
Short, put away again. Only 3 men on the leg side, so it's dangerous. You better get it right, and Siddle didn't.
He just feel like Joe Warner predicted the short one. He's caned the full one down the ground. It's going to be an extra effort, maybe a bit shorter, and he just helped that on its way. The Australians have to drive the boundaries. It goes without saying, but it's only going to come from consistency with the ball. And maybe just hoping now, because these two batsmen are going, particularly Jay Warner, that he just makes a simple error. Because you can't see it currently.
Oh, that's good bowling again. The risk is all with the batsman. Australia struggled to hit fours. Sri Lanka, no problems.
That's a better delivery, though. That's the place to bowl. It's the way you're going to get a little nick. Unlucky here.
Peter Siddle back in this Australian outfit. He's had a wretched off-season. He's had a stress fracture he had to get over and has worked overtime. Was actually training with his beloved Carlton AFL team to work on the fitness.
That's it! And caught. So the onslaught might have finished. Joe Wardner has anyway.
Boy, they needed that. Desperately needed that. So, Mahela out, caught behind. Beautiful delivery, actually. Just moved away a little bit. Found the outside edge. Nicely taken. So at last, 1 for 35.
Wins International Summer of Cricket, brought to you by KFC's Outback Bucket. There's plenty to get you through a big summer of cricket. Can't beat that taste.
Hi. Did you know that when you call the Quit Line, you can order a free quit pack or speak to one of our friendly advisors? Next time you call, why not take up both options? 1-3-QUIT. It's that easy.
Right, a wicket brings not to the wicket Kumar Sangakkara, the captain, but Dinesh Chandimal, number 17 for Sri Lanka. He's a wicketkeeper, but a very impressive top-order batsman as well, according to Tom Moody, former coach. Same field employed. Siddle just needs to do the same stuff again.
Great effort from Siddle. You say he's worked extremely hard. He trained with, pretty sure it was the Carlton AFL side, although he does support the Kangaroos, so I don't want to offend him there. Or the Kangaroos. He's James Brayshaw, the president in particular. And, it's great to see him back out there, and that is a very good breakthrough for the Aussies. They needed it.
Chandimal walks across, he stumps it a little bit more, times it beautifully. So there's pressure on for a three here. Chandimal wants it. Dilshan says no. So Chandimal off the mark, 1 for 37 after four.
Next, give force your laptop. Next, give force your YouTube. Next, give force your status update. Introducing the Big Pun Ultimate Device. There's nothing faster.
Big Pun Mobile Broadband. $39.95 a month for 7 gigabytes. Plus, get a free Big Pun Ultimate USB on a 24-month plan after rebate for eligible customers.
Yeah, there was a lot of pressure put on the Australians by Mahela Jay Wardner. They're 24 from 16. He tried everything, and it was all aggression. Peter Siddle got him doing something a little different. Through some good, consistent bowling, he's picked up the wicket. Dirk Nennis has been anything but consistent. One over for 13. He's back on from the Prindeval stand end. And now it's Dilshan into the attack with a four.
Oh, Dilshan, if he starts to cut loose, yeah, there could be a bit of carnage around. He is deadly. And he's the sort of player that will just throw the bat. He's been actually biding his time just a little bit. Jay Wardner has been doing all the damage. But, boy, he can hit them.
He's just using the angle from Nanis there beautifully.
Well, that's good line. Little inside edge up onto the elbow. Might have carried off that pad a little bit. Nanis was all over it. But I liked what Peter Siddle did to Mahela Jay Wardner. He backed away and hit down the ground early in the over. and he learned his lesson. So gave his stumps up and hit a magnificent shot. You've got to say to yourself, that was decent bowling. That time, Mahala Jayawardena was back deep in his crease and the leg cutter worked. So really good, solid play to get a wicket.
Well, Siddle very quickly summed it up, didn't he? He thought, well, that first ball didn't really deserve to go down the ground for four, so if I get the ball in the right area and he hits another one like that, fair play to your batsman. But you've got to hit a terrific shot to do so. And the bonus of that delivery was it just rolled away from you. You'll just notice it straightened just slightly. And that's what grabs the outside edge.
And when you see it, just a slight straightening on TV, it feels a lot more for the players. That was a really good leg cutter. Doesn't show up on TV anywhere near as much. That's close. He's right across in front of his stumps. He's got to go.
Well, you called it, Ian Healy. He did move across there, trying to work it away on the onside. Just be interesting to see whether it just straightened down the line a little bit. But a huge appeal from the Australians. They needed that second wicket quickly. So Chandimal is out, LBW to Nannis. This is the dismissal again. Let's see where the pitch is. Close to leg.
Always tough for a left armer to get an LBW in this fashion, particularly Nannis. He doesn't get really close to the stumps. But because the batsman wandered across, he's now wandering off the field. 2 for 42 now.
KFC's new Double Crunch Burger Combo is here with two fresh 100% breast fillet chicken crispy strips, creamy pepper mayo, crisp lettuce on a warm sesame seed bun, plus chips and a drink for just $5.95. The best lunch deals are now at KFC, all for just $5.95 each.
The captain in now at 2 for 42 off 4.4 overs. I guess every partnership from here on in is vital to be broken by the Aussies, but no more so than this one. Sangakkara off the mark. Just a single. Siddle. He'll nearly keep the ball in the hand because he's back on in one delivery's time.
Interesting that the captain's out there now. Good to see that they sent the youngster in, Chandimal. I'll give him a chance. They're trying to develop their young players. Batsman probably thought that. Sure, he probably thought, well, I'll get away with this because it pitched outside leg stump. Let's see. Yeah, well, he was right. Just.
That's good pace. It's good pace off the bat as well. Siddle does well. Picks it up left-handed, steps over the rope, flicks it back, and gets a rocket arm back to Haddon. Five overs, can you believe it? 2 for 45.
Harvey Norman, Australia's number one outdoor furniture retailer, launches the new season range in store now. This is the year to take your indoors outside with quality outdoor furniture. Choose from aluminium, stone, wicker and timber. Our new exciting range is in stock now. Plus, all the accessories you'll ever need. Enhance the look of your home and your lifestyle. Do the deal now and enjoy your outdoor living. Best prices, best advice, best range in stock now at Harvey Norman, your number one destination for outdoor furniture. Go!
Big crowd in for the first 2020 of the summer. Australia, Sri Lanka, they're enjoying every moment of it, especially the Sri Lankan facets of it. Changing the commentary box, Tom Moody and Mark Taylor are with Mark Nicholas.
Thank you to Ian Healy. And there's a beautiful line from Peter Siddle to ask a question of Kumar Sangakkara, who comes in on the back of a terrific start from Mahala Jayawardena. Tilakaratna Dilshan is still out there. Chandimal's gone. When Mark Taylor and I were last in these seats, he said 130 plus, and Australia are right in the game. Looks like it too.
Well, they're in the game all right, although Sri Lanka has started well. There's no doubt they're on top at the moment, but I reckon there'll be a few Australian selectors who won't be all that disappointed. They want obviously Australia to play a bit better, but they'll be delighted with Peter Siddle, the way he started. He looks fit to me, looks really fit. Jones running in. That's going to go probably for four leg buys. That will annoy him. He's kept the two down there. Dirk Nannis keeps it the two and does well, but Peter Siddle's running in nicely. He's had, fortunately, he's had back stress fractures and all sorts of problems, but he does look as fit as I've ever seen him look, and he's bustling and bowling beautifully.
Yeah, and he's generating some good pace, and one thing that's really stood out to me is the pace he's running in. He really is running in very hard and looking to hit his areas, and he's hit his areas pretty well so far.
Well, he'll regard every ball that he bowls as an opportunity to tell the selectors, I want to be in Brisbane on November the 25th. With competition for places for the first test match in the seam bowling department. Very evident, and what have we got here? I think we might have a saved boundary.
I think they're just checking to see if there was some part of Dirk Nannis' body on the rope, or that ball was still tangled up in his, looked like it about his left foot. Still checking it again. He does well, but it doesn't stop the ball clean. You'll see it just bobbles out of his hand there. Now, then what happens? His legs, is it on the rope? Maybe not. He may have saved two.
Key is, does he touch the ball with his knees here while his feet are touching the ropes? And there's no evidence that says he does. And on that evidence, the umpire would have to say it's only two. And two leg byes it is. Dirk Nannis has made the stop.
This Australian side, you were talking about Peter Siddle a moment ago there. It's great, honestly, for Australia's hopes that he is back bowling at his best. When he bowled against England, I think about 4 years ago, he bowls a much more consistent line than some of the Australian bowlers we've seen in recent times. I think Australia needs someone like a Peter Siddle or possibly a Stuart Clarke just to bowl a consistent line and length on or around about off stump.
Quickly, you can't mess with Tillakaratna Dilshan. He's got every stroke in the book.
Well, if there's any player in the Sri Lankan lineup that plays a short ball well and welcomes it, it's Dilshan. Siddle just erring on the short side there, and he's onto it like a flash. He does like to play the hook and the pull, and he sits back and puts that one away for another boundary.
The days when players from the subcontinent found it hard to play on bouncier pitches are gone, really. There's so many opportunities to travel now and play away from home. In fact, it'll only be someone who's never toured before that would maybe be alarmed by the extra bounce. Dilshan, as Tom Moody points out, relishes it.
Yeah, I remember when I was working with the Sri Lankans, Dilshan requested to get in on the hard wickets, and for myself or the assistant coach at the time, Trevor Penny, to throw balls at him around the chest, around the head, so he could just sharpen his skills, improve his technique, because he knew that's the step he had to make if he was going to be consistently successful at the top level.
Ah, that's one of the world's great players. Kumar Sangakkara is off and running. It's 2 for 57.
Fresh has a fresh new look with top quality meats. A sumptuous selection of cheeses, small goods, gourmet meals and salads. A wide range of groceries from Tasmania, Australia and the world. And our fresh fruit and vegetables are second to none. Call in soon. Fresh, from the grower to you.
Sri Lanka going nicely. 77 needed to win the game off 84 balls. Australia making just 133 the suspicion was always that it wasn't enough, not on a good, quite bouncy surface here at the Wacker with a fast outfield. It's a hard ground to defend. Sri Lanka made an excellent start with the ball. It wasn't until Brad Haddin and Steve Smith got together in a impressive partnership that Australia had anything to sing about. Here's John Hastings on debut. He's a big man. In fact, he's a huge man, isn't he, Tom?
Big lad. Looks very strong. Hits the deck hard. It's his first game for Australia in India in the recent washed-out one-day series. And did a good job in that one match in Vizag. Bowled very well. Got a couple of wickets. There's plenty of runs scored on that at that venue. And he changed his pace well, hit the wicket well. He bowled just that back of a length and made it difficult for the players to get on the front foot. But he's got a good subtle change of pace. And as I said, he bowls pretty tight lines and hits that deck hard.
You said he's a big man, so he's up to about your chin. Is he? Is that where he's up to?
Yeah, he's not quite in the giant in the giant sort of level, but he'd be 6 foot four. So, yeah, he's around about chin or maybe get to the nose.
He's got size, what, 12 shoes? Which, what are you, about 16, 17?
No. I'm 12 or 13, depending whether it's UK or US. But, yeah, no, he's a big lad.
He's got a tough assignment here. Kumar Sangakkara, the man he's bowling to, is about as good a player as you're going to see. There's obviously people like Sachin Tendulkar, who's in terrific form with this guy. He's a great player to watch. Jay Wardner there, who kick-started this innings with a quick-fire 24. Hit five boundaries in that 24. And he's also a good player to watch. Played a different sort of innings today. I often see him stepping away and hitting balls through cover, but such a good time as a Sri Lankans.
Yeah, well, the key to both Mahela and Kumar Sangakkara is how late they play the ball. You know, Mahela's more of a wristier player than what Kumar is. But since he's been elevated into that opening position in 2020 cricket, he has played a lot more of an aggressive role up front. And he's a very difficult, you know, player to bowl to because he's got shots all around the ground, back foot and front foot. And as we've said, beautiful timer of the ball.
Looking at that wagon wheel or spider, it looks like, doesn't it, where all the boundaries are hit and all the singles and twos and threes come from. You wouldn't see a wagon wheel like that from a Sri Lankan player or Sri Lankans in Perth some 10 years ago. All the runs would be square of the wicket and probably be behind the wicket. Now you're seeing some lovely straight drives, some cover drives. Sure, you're hitting the little clips off the toes, which they've always been very good at. But probably got a pull shot there on the onside and one clip on the leg side from Sangakkara last over was a delightful shot, but you're seeing them score all around the wicket these days, not just behind it.
Now, that's a good start by John Hastings. Penrith boys benefited from the move to Victoria. It's 2 for 59.
Alan's got a new girlfriend.
Ta-da!
Oh boy.
A new home.
Isn't this nice? Eating together as a family?
Everything is perfect. Until his ex turns up.
Now what?
Who will he choose? Wins new 2.5 Men. Monday, 7:30.
How far will a classic Aussie road trip go before it turns bad? Plus, the Chaser Boys. New Top Gear Australia, Tuesday.
That's it. A very comfortable start to this run chase for Sri Lanka. Every opportunity to score has been taken. In fact, they look a team well sort of tuned, well oiled. They did in the field, they did with the ball, and they are with the bat.
Yeah, they certainly have got world-class players. I think what a lot of people don't appreciate is the likes of Sangakkara and Jai Wardner, who we've talked about, both average in the mid-50s in Test cricket. Now, that is a substantial average over a long period of time. Both played over 100 Test matches, so they are pure class players, world-class players.
And Tom, I mean, a lot of the young guys are impressive cricketers too. There's no doubt that this period of Sri Lankan cricket, with, as you say, the Jayawardene, the Sangakkara axis, the Muralitharan, Chamindavas, Sanat Jayasuriya, all those sort of cricketers have been wonderful examples for these youngsters who have aspired to achieve the same great things.
Well, it's so important in a team setup, isn't it, to have role models. And you couldn't get two better role models than both Mahela and Kumar. And as you say, the likes of the Angelo Matthews, the Chandamals, you know, the Kapilgetteras, all these players, Upul Taranga, who's not playing in this particular match, is sitting on the bench, all are benefiting by just being surrounded by these classy players.
When you went there, were you surprised by the culture for cricket? I've often likened it when I first went there, when I first went to Barbados, where the people live and breathe the game. They play it on the beaches and in the fields and any opportunity for bat and ball.
Yeah, look, there is a, you know, an obvious passion in the subcontinent, and Sri Lanka, India, both very similar. There's a real passion for the game, and they, whenever, wherever they can play the game, they will play it. Whether it's in the corridors of the hotels, whether it's in the driveways, whether it's on the street when the traffic's going crazy, they're playing cricket.
But like Barbados, it's just a little island. I mean, India is a vast, vast land, but Sri Lanka is just a little place, and it's kind of almost like a, you catch the bug and it spreads quickly around that little place, you know?
Well, I think the bug was seriously caught when they won the 96 World Cup. You know, Arjuna Ratnatunga's team, that was a significant moment in Sri Lankan cricket because it gave them belief and it gave them hope that they could compete on the world stage in any form of the game. And their growth since that point has been significant.
They did it in such great style. Mark Taylor may not want to remember it. And I don't mean it in a fashion to in any way belittle Australia losing that final. Just that the way that at the top of the order with Jayasuriya and Kalawatana, they attacked, the way that the middle order understood how to dominate that period with the brilliance of Aravinda De Silva and Arjuna himself, the cleverness of the bowling, the intelligence, the changes of pace even in those early days. There was a lot of thought went into their play.
Yeah, and unfortunately in that game, from an Australian point of view, they beat us on our own game. It wasn't the explosive opening batsman who got the runs. It was Arjuna and Aravinda De Silva who made 100. Played beautifully in that final and chased down about 250. Far too good for us on the day. 2 for 64.
Mitsubishi delivers outstanding value across the entire range this October. So get into your nearest Mitsubishi dealer and test drive the limited edition Triton Active 4x4. With tub liner, sports bar, tonneau cover, tow bar with rear step and powerful turbo diesel with up to 3-tonne towing, just $39,990 drive away. And with Diamond Advantage, Australia's best new car warranty and capped price servicing, Mitsubishi delivers you worry-free motoring. See your Mitsubishi dealer today.
Love that car.
Right, Sri Lanka 2 for 64. Australia have to find a wicket or two. Sangakkara's on strike. To the big fella, John Hastings. David Hussey is out there and mic'd up as a wide is called. Huss, of course, has played all round the world in 2020 cricket for the Knight Riders in the IPL, for Nottingham in England, for Victoria. He's been so successful. Huss, you got to make something happen.
Yeah, we do, actually. Yeah, we're probably about 40 runs short. And at the moment, we've got to break this partnership. The bloke on strike's quite a handy player.
Correct. So how, in a short game like this, where things bang, bang, they happen almost before some of the players blink, you've captained a fair few T20 sides. How do you make something happen? What magic can you produce?
Well, it's just one of those things. Bowl the ball of your life, or take that specky catch, or that run out, or something. Just do something out of the ordinary to change the momentum for the game.
So not something unusual tactically, a massive field change, a massive different tactic, lots of short pitches, or nothing like that.
Yeah, you can do that. Yeah, most definitely. I think when Warnie was skipper of Rajasthan Royals, he had like the bumper practice, a lot of people around the bat, and he changes the momentum that way. Probably a little bit more structured, I guess. And Yeah, try and hit the top of off with the odd bumper, I guess.
Deliveries like that would do.
Yeah, that'll do. I'd like a bit more wood on the ball, though, to be fair. Nick the first slip would be lovely.
You're sounding a bit breathless there, Huss. You're covering a few yards?
Yeah, I've covered a few yards. I've been back with square leg for a bit and then deep points and running all over the place. But in this game, if you keep moving the whole 20 overs, you generally create something and hopefully a momentum change for your team.
One more for you before we say thank you. The pitch, a lot of talk about the Wacker pitch these last few years. We get the impression this one's got enough in it. It's some bit of extra bounce and pace.
Yeah, I reckon it's an excellent cricket wicket. I played a Shield game here earlier on this month and it was a fantastic cricket wicket and almost back to the Wacker old self. Like a bit of pace, bit of bounce, but a bit in it for the bowlers as well. If you hit the seam, you generally get something out of it. So should make for an interesting Ashes test later on in the year.
There you go. Go make things happen. Huss, have a word in pubs here.
Yeah, I'll see
Change
what I can
that
do.
Field.
Might have a bowl.
It's interesting when you mention about, you know, trying to make things happen, movement in the field. Now, that's one of the things that is talked about, particularly in 2020 cricket, is making sure every member of the team is active and moving, whether it's backing up or just getting into position. It really just can change that momentum and, you know, the Australians definitely need wickets here and they need to make changes. And whether that's bowling changes, whether that's fielding changes, they've got plenty of bowling options out there.
Yeah, and as you say, they've got to keep that momentum going in the field. You see them jogging between deliveries at left and right-handers. Mark Nicklaus just asked Dave Hussey about what's it like when you move around. You do a lot of moving in the 20 overs out there. And the sides that can keep that going and keep that momentum are the ones you do make those breakthroughs.
Whoa! No wide call by Bruce Oxenford. It's 2 for 68.
If you're looking to invest or buy a new home, yes is a beautiful word. Get the advantage you need. Apply for pre-approval. Talk to a MyState financial home loan expert today.
Hello again. Hello. Just called to say hello.
Target is 134 for Sri Lanka to win this first international match of the Australian summer. We've got so much for you this summer. 3 one-dayers to come against the Sri Lankans in Melbourne, Sydney and Brisbane. And then on November the 25th, again at the Gabba, the start of the Ashes. We've got a little teaser too on Sunday the 21st when the All-Stars play against the Fans 11. A chance for you to go online and help pick a team to play against the All-Stars. Really does promise so much, but Australia needs some magic here if they're to get off to a winning start. Peter Siddle's coming in at a nice lick. He's now been taken out of the attack. Didn't start well for the Australians, did it? Sri Lanka got a lot right with the ball early on.
I think also, this is the first Sri Lankan wicket. Jay Wardner caught behind there. That hadn't. And that was Chanda Marla Judge, LBW to Naz. Probably a little unlucky. That might have just pitched outside leg. But I think the difference has been that the Sri Lankans have played authentic cricket shots to a lot of deliveries. Yeah, there's been a little bit of backing away and hitting through the offside, but they haven't tried to loft the ball as much as the Australians. And they've used the pace of the delivery and the pace of this pitch probably better than the Australians have used when they were batting.
Yeah, you would have thought if you're a neutral and didn't understand where the Sri Lankans have come from and what the Australians are used to, you would have thought that the Sri Lankans own this turf and understand this ground and understand the pace of the wicket and the bounce and are used to it. and the Australians were struggling to find their feet. Now, we know Australia's been in India for a period of time, but not certainly all this team.
Yeah, we were chatting earlier, Tom, weren't we, about the way the Australians batted. And look, there's no doubt the Sri Lankans bowled very well. I think that's a point that we need to harp on, because they bowled particularly well. They changed their pace well and they changed their bowlers regularly, so they kept the Australians off balance. But the Australians did look to play big shots. They looked to loft the ball over the infield rather than just allow that ball to come onto the bat as it does here in Perth and use that pace to hit the ball through the field.
Well, it is so important to keep your shape, as what we would say in the coach's box. You know, the player as a batsman needs to keep his shape, and the man on strike, Sangakkara, does that so well. The game's about timing and composure. You know, okay, it's a faster game, it's 2020, and they've got through a quick two there, well run. But it's obviously an accelerated game, but still the principles of batting are pretty much the same. You need to have composure, you need to have balance. And also, if you have both those things, you find timing. And if you've got the timing, you will hit the fours, you will hit the sixes. It's not all about losing shape and trying to slog the ball out of the park.
Well, we can have a look back at the Australian wickets. I mentioned a moment ago that Australia found it difficult against that impressive Sri Lankan bowling early on. They really did get the length right, and even the natural strikers of the ball, David Warners and Shane Watson, found it very difficult.
Yeah, look at those first two dismissals there. Exactly the point that Tom Moody was making. Both batsmen lost the shape. No, they're both backing away, looking to hit the ball straight back over the bowler's head. Shane Watson probably trying to play a bit more of an authentic shot, a lofted shot, sure, but his shape was okay, but there was a man back.
Back live, and again, the outside edge is beaten. Clint Mackay's got a little movement off the seam. 10 overs gone, it's 2 for 73.
Mitsubishi delivers outstanding value across the entire range this October. So get into your nearest Mitsubishi dealer and test drive the limited edition Triton Active 4x4. With tub liner, sports bar, tonneau cover, tow bar with rear step and powerful turbo diesel with up to 3-ton towing, just $39,990 drive away. And with Diamond Advantage, Australia's best new car warranty and capped price servicing, Mitsubishi delivers you worry-free motoring. See your Mitsubishi dealer today.
Love that car.
...61 from 60 balls by T20 standards. That should be a walk in the park for the Sri Lankans. Ian Healy, Tony Gregg and Michael Slater come into the commentary box.
Thanks, Nico. You'd think it should be, but you just never know. Steve Smith, the leggies, are now into the attack, and he could change things. We saw some good bounce with the spin bowling from the Sri Lankans. What can Steve Smith produce?
So I suppose that's the question. A wicket, that's all that he needs to think about. If he can sneak one of them out there quickly without conceding too many runs, get a new batsman in. That's the problem here, is Dilshan's got 25, Sangakkara 17. They're relatively settled.
We saw some spin as well for the offies in the first innings, so maybe Smith could get one or two to grip.
Down. Target to start. Yeah, Rundeev got three wickets and bowled very well. And then fateful over for the Australians. It was 2 and 4 from the first two deliveries, and then he got a couple of wickets to finish it up. And Smith needs to do the same, but not with short long hops. The long hop will go the journey every time, particularly when you're bowling to the quality of Sangakkara. Dispatched with ease.
Oh, he loved it. He loved it. The opportunity to get a long hop and go with the spin, if there was to be any. He just lays back. He can hit on the front foot or the back foot, square the wicket or down the ground.
He's just working that away nicely with the spin as well. Yes, I think so far, Randeev's probably my man of the match. 3 for 25, got three important wickets. He got Hatton out when he was 35 and looking dangerous. Also Steve Smith out. Few of the Sri Lankan batsmen will be pushing for the man of the match as well, but Rundeev bowled beautifully.
Yeah, Smith probably trying to overspin to the left-hander. Maybe the slider is the go.
There'll be a couple at least in this one. This one's behind point. In fact, it's four. timing outstanding from Dilshan. And this will hurt the Australians in one over. The run rate required comes under six, so less than a ball. Run a ball, I should say. It's getting easier and easier. Partnership worth 40.
Once again, really looking to side spin it. So the pressure of the game is enough. And Steve Smith's putting himself under some pressure, looking for some real big turn. Just dragging it down a little bit and erring in width that time, and a fumbling misfield. The Australians are rattled.
I think the great thing about the Rundeef spell and the fact that you've got him as man of the match at the moment, Greg, is that there's life for the spinner in this form of the game. There's so much sport talk about the spinning effect dying out and captains not being able to use them. But when a captain gets it right and the bowler gets it right, there's still a great, great role for them. 2 for 83.
Hi. Did you know you can order a free quit pack online? So if you're thinking of quitting, just go to www.quittes.org.au and we'll send one out to you. It's that easy.
Hello again, hello. Just called to say hello.
Wickets required for Australia. Runs 51 from 54. Even with a couple of wickets, there's plenty remaining for Sri Lanka. Plenty of batting to come. So the real challenge for Michael Clarke is to fire up Manus now. And he's starting his third over. He's been very expensive. He's gone for four fours in the two overs he's bowled already. And a lot of them have just been that angle across the right-hander has just slid onto the bat beautifully.
It's just going back to the Australian innings and finishing off for you those wickets. This was Hussey, beautifully taken by Sangakkara. He really did look very, very much in charge and very good. Look at this with the gloves absolutely latching onto everything. Malinga on that occasion. The last two wickets to fall. Smith was out stumped there, beautifully stumped again. Sangakkara into the action. And Haddon there going for the big hit down towards square leg right at the end of the innings. Nicely taken. And, of course, this was the run out right at the end of the innings. Good running collision there, but they got two for one.
Joe Wooden decided to do a slide save there, and that teased Hastings into the second run, and then he picked up the run out. It was nicely. I'm not sure about Dirk Nannis. He's been all one pace tonight. I don't know whether he's got slow ball variations. I think he's been at his most effective in 2020 cricket when the batsmen are coming at him. They have it. They can just wait for some average deliveries on tonight's total, but he's got to find a little bit more variation to change things up and get some false shots.
I think you make a good point there, Heels. There's no doubt that a real bonus as we see an overthrow from the Australians. Messy work from them in the field. Won't please Michael Clarke. But the subtle variation from all the bowlers from Sri Lanka was outstanding. Their accuracy was there to start with, but then they were able to make these subtle variations to a number of deliveries that were deceiving, as was that throw. No one backing up.
46 to win or 51 balls. Not happy, not happy.
There's the short one. A little bit of spice in that delivery. 142.4 Ks. Bit of meaning. Can't get the breakthrough. This partnership, 46.
So they've got to just keep chipping away at those wickets, don't they? That'll create a little bit of panic. Get the Sri Lankans on their back foot a little bit. Sometimes a run out, really brilliant bit of fielding, can make a contribution to that sort of situation.
Thought there was an edge there for a second. And anguish from the bowler. He is putting in. He's been revved up to come back in and get a wicket. That's what he's got to do this over. He's only got one ball remaining, though.
Yeah, that's right. It's been good hustle. Good hustle. Sits the seam up straight. That one, he nips it away at good pace. And the short ball's been employed, so at least he's trying plenty. And he's proving hard to get onto in this over, his third. Just a little edge going your way, then a little run through the middle order. Who knows?
He's gone short again. That'll be punished with a wide. Just too much of something different, I suppose, from Nannis. And this is at the time that the frustration could really settle in on what the Australians are trying to achieve.
Well, it has to be asked, what are they trying to achieve in this week? You know, there's been reports that it's an experimental type week, and this team's just New South Wales and Victorians with no Hodge. Hodge is the best one-day 2020 and one-day cricketer in the country. He's nowhere to be seen. So what is it?
Just one to the man in the deep. Eight overs remain. I don't know that Sri Lanka will need all of them. 2 for 90.
We were bickering away before we crashed into a farmer's crop.
I was trying to launch my boat.
I was in some kind of choke.
I just didn't see the lobby.
You and God may, I never claim.
And he gets the same as I did.
What about me?
Amy Safe Driver Awards for drivers who don't claim.
Lucky are with Amy.
Two for 90, Dilshan 33, Sangakkara 25, and a very good contribution from Jay Wardner, 24 from 16. Some delightful strokes in that 24. And it was something the Australians weren't able to get, establish a partnership at the top of the batting. Just helps everything else flow, like that one to the boundary.
Yes, that's a beautiful shot as well. Not the right place to pitch it, not the right length either. So I've got to say, I'm with you, Ian Healy, on this business of you play an international. It doesn't matter whether it's a test match, one day international, 2020. It's playing for your country, the best team. End of section.
100%. Not sure we're entirely seeing that. One thing I'm seeing too much of is Australia losing fixtures in all forms of the game. And at some stages, there may be not enough change. We'll see how the season pans out, though. It's going to be a positive one in terms of what we're going to witness with the Ashes around the corner. But first up in this week, we've got the 2020, and we've got 3 1-day internationals against Sri Lanka. It'll be Wednesday in Melbourne, Friday in Sydney, and then we're up to the Gabba for Sunday. Just give us a feel of what Australia are doing as a team. And from what I'm seeing tonight, they're going to have their work cut out against the Sri Lankans. They're in some sort of form. Nicely played. Big job in the outfield. No, can't stop the two.
They can coast now, can't they? They've got themselves into a nice situation. Good partnership here between two very experienced players. 37 to get or 45 balls.
Not traditionally in their nature to coast either, is it? They like to entertain, especially when they've established a partnership. 55 is the partnership between these two. So we'll still see some enterprising stroke play, I'm sure. Making it look easy.
Oh, he's crunched it. Absolutely hammered it. No chance in the deep.
He didn't have to wait long to see how they were going to play it. That is a beauty. That is awesome stuff. Dilshan on to 39. It's, you know, Hastings hasn't really pitched the ball in bad areas this over so far, and yet Sangakkara's flipped him off the middle stump across the leg side for four. Dilshan's hit one on the up outside off for four. They are victims of great batting.
Goes the other way now, and it'll be a race on. He'll come back for two more. Expensive over here from Hastings. He's trying his heart out.
Right, want to know who's the smartest in your family? A little question that pops up from time to time.
Oh, easy, that one.
Watch the National IQ test Tuesday week, that is, 7:30, and settle the debate once and for all. I suppose, Ian Healy, you are easily the smartest in your family, are you?
Not much to beat there, Tone.
We might come back to that. 203.
No, we won't.
There's been an explosion at Tennant's Mitre 10 at the fork in the road, Kingston. Now a megastore where you'll be totally blown away. Building supplies with racks and racks of timber and sheet product. Drive your usual car right to the stock. Hardware and tools. A paint department and plumbing department that has to be seen to be believed. All the supplies you need to have your garden looking at its best year round. Tennant's Mitre 10, Kingston and Huonville. Just come to the fork in the road.
That equation's got easier. 31 from 42 balls remaining. 8 wickets in hand. And Ian Healy thought it was a little bit later in Brisbane. It's still only 10:30 and your family have heard what you've just said, Ian.
I'm in a spot of bother there, Michael. But I'll back them to be in bed, actually. Halloween might keep the young fella up.
Trick or treat. Down the ground, and that'll be a boundary as well. It was upish from Sangakkara. But just like Jay Wardner, he's the left-hand version of an elegant stroke maker.
Yeah, it was upish, you're right, but the timing was there. It just seems to fly off his bat. Really does whistle away to the boundary. Wonderful timer of the ball.
He's got really good wrists, Sangakkara. He plays that onside flick you see quite often, and we've seen it a couple of times in this innings in particular. He tried it there, and then all of a sudden he'll straighten the wrists and bang down the ground. It's a very effective technique. 33 from 30 deliveries.
Yeah, rarely gets loose and loses his shape. He's got that little circular back lift, but then the plane of the bat comes straight down the line of the ball in a nice, simple, wristy flick, a bunt, and then the outstanding pull shot, the flip pull off the hip we saw last over.
Oh, how good. Really, that is a smoking shot. Well, on that note, we'll get down to the boundary. Mark Nicklaus is down there.
Thanks, lads. Yeah, I've got Paul Moeschke with me, who's marketing manager for KFC. Great to have you back on board.
Thank you very much. It's great to be part of a fast-growing and moving game, and it's thanking all our franchisees and employees for being part of this great sponsorship for KFC.
Just let Pete settle by another delivery at Kuma Sangakkara, nothing from it. You've got a new promotion to tell us about as well, Paul.
Yeah, this year we'll be going back into the community and supporting all the clubs. We'll be running a promotion. If you want to get involved, go to kfc.com.au. We'll be trying to get the fans involved as well as all the players for 2020 and doing something great for KFC.
Sounds terrific. Give that to us once more. kfc.com.au.
kfc.com.au to get your club involved.
Terrific. Good to have you on board. We really appreciate your support. We'll go back upstairs.
Thanks, guys. The Colonel's been happy. There he is in the background there smiling. The Australians are not smiling at the moment, though. 2 for 112, Sri Lanka. 37 balls remaining. Their task now, quite simple, you would think. 3.56 is the required run rate.
Well, this is one of the most impressive, probably the most impressive Sri Lankan performances in a shorter form of the game, maybe all forms of the game in Australia. They've mastered the Perth conditions, they've monstered and mastered the Australian attack, and they've had the Australian top and middle order misfire through great bowling. Complete stuff.
Four 14 overs gone, it's 2 for 112 still. Certainly has been impressive, as Ian Healy was saying. It's been one of the smarter performances we've seen from Sri Lanka in Australia, particularly at the Wacker. Steve Smith continues. And Steve Smith gets pulled to the onside. It was a use of feet there from Sangakkara.
Good bowling by Smith. The way he should be looking at this is a chance to get a wicket. You know, Warne's career was triggered with a 3 for 11 at a time where Sri Lanka should have beaten us as a team in Colombo. But so Smith could get a little top edge, get something going, you never know.
Oh, that'll be out. No trouble there. Brad Haddon had all the time in the world, and Steve Smith will get a breakthrough. A little too late, but good bowling all the same.
Yeah, typical Dilshan, though. Lost his head completely. He didn't need to do that. This is the way he plays, though. Look at this. He was hitting this one over the top of the pavilion roof and missed it completely. Missed it by miles, easily stumped, and exactly what Ian Healy was saying. A little wicket here, and who knows? There might just be a little panic set in. It'll have to be a big one. 3 for 130.
Hi. Did you know that when you call the quit line, you can order a free quit pack or speak to one of our friendly advisors. Next time you call, why not take up both options? 1-3-QUIT. It's that easy.
Hello. Hello.
Dad, what are you doing in there, mate? Get out!
Just called to see.
Don't do anything stupid.
Hello.
Pereira at the crease, the left-hander. He's got a big hitting reputation. A real tonker, they say. Hasn't played a lot of cricket, but we'd like to see a couple of big hits. The Australians don't want to see that, but he's out there with that purpose in mind. I'm not going to slow down. Sri Lanka, well, he's gone for it straight away. He'll get lucky. Totally mistimed and falls just outside the circle in front of the man charging in from the deep.
What sort of shot's that? I think Smith bowled the perfect ball, a little slider that was going to keep going outside off. That's the leg spinner to Dilshan, who just wanted a piece of it, didn't get it, which is great for Smith.
Just trying to get it over and done with, wasn't he, Dilshan? He was da-da-da-da. As you say, Greg, he was trying to put that over the stand, wasn't he? Well, there's nothing wrong with that. He was on a roll. You get away with it in 2020 cricket. And now Sangakkara, all control. What I love about this shot is that it's the use of the feet. Yeah, he drags it to the onside, straight to a gap. But it's always in control.
That's an incredibly risky shot made to look so simple. Good ball by Smith. It's exactly what you want him doing, sliding across the left-hander, and he just advances, stays with it, smacks it.
Oh, sing.
See, that's clever. That time down the wicket and then wasn't quite there, adjusted. So not a bad over, but some good batting too. 3 for 119.
You won't believe who gets caught. Red-handed.
That's not what it looks like.
New The Mentalist, Monday.
If you're looking to invest or buy a new home, yes is a beautiful word. Get the advantage you need. Apply for pre-approval. Talk to a MyState financial home loan expert today.
New season Survivor, Tuesday 9:40 on WIN.
Well, 15 games prior to this one, Sri Lanka have played at the Wacker. They'd only won one out of the 15. This is going to be their second, you would think. They need a further 15, 30 balls remaining, 7 wickets in hand. Surely, no. You're going to get home when you're in that sort of situation. Terrific batting from the top order. And joining me in the commentary box now, it's Mark Taylor and Tom Moody.
Yeah, you'd be a brave man to back against him here, Michael, particularly with Sangakkara at the crease. He's, as I was saying earlier, is one of the class players in world cricket. He's made 100 on this tour already against Queensland in a 50-over game. I think he made about 110 off 90-odd deliveries up at the Gabba. And then didn't play the 2020 match against New South Wales at Blacktown. He left himself out of that game because he's in such good form, and he's shown us that form tonight.
Well, they're his career stats, and they're very impressive. Been around for some time now, drawing close to the 100 test mark, which is a real milestone for any player. A very rich average of 56.
Well, it just shows that you can play in all forms of the game and play in every one of them successfully. Those stats from test right through to the T20, outstanding. And probably a little like Gilly, having the keeping. He hasn't always kept in every one of those games, but the keeping sort of very much works hand in hand with his batting at times.
Yeah, look, I think, well, he's only recent, probably the last 2 years, given up the gloves in the longer form in the test cricket. But in one day cricket, he obviously still plays that role as the keeper batsman, because it obviously allows them to have further depth in their bowling or further depth in their batting. So wonderful player to have of that quality and class to be in your top order. And Australia had that luxury with Adam Gilchrist, as you mentioned, for many years, him keeping and batting at the top of the order in one day cricket very successfully.
It was interesting looking at his stats there. That one day average of 36 is a little lower than I thought. I would have thought he was a man of around about 42, 43 average in one day cricket. And I just wonder if maybe the keeping there has made it tough for him, particularly in subcontinent. If you happen to field first, to keep for 50 overs and then have to bat is not easy.
Yeah, there's no question that has a bearing. And, you know, he's a hard man to budge down the order.
No.
And that's the end of the over. And a maiden over. Sri Lanka 3 for 119.
The mysterious pain relief powers of the green-lipped mussel. On A Current Affair, does this deep-sea discovery hold the key to relieving and preventing joint pain and arthritis?
I have noticed a difference.
Plus, lost Super Lotto. Aussies hitting the jackpot, finding tens of thousands of dollars they never knew they had.
Do something about it.
We show you how to cash in. And the magic light bulb that lasts 20 years. How it can slash 90% off your lighting bills. A Current Affair Monday.
Well, 4 overs remaining. Sri Lanka just need 15 runs to win this 2020 match. Smith will continue. Oh, that's beautifully hit. That's a long way back. That's about the biggest today.
Well, let's get the old tape measure out on that baby, because that's going a million miles. They said he was a tonker, and that's what a tonker can do.
Yeah, well, having spoken to a couple of Sri Lankans early in the day, they said that he does hit a long ball, and that one is a long one. And that's what he's there, because he wouldn't normally be batting in front of Angelo Matthews and Chamra Kapalgatara, but Pereira's been lifted into the up the order to finish this game off for Sri Lanka.
Well, the last over was a maiden. I think he was at the other end and says, "Hey, Skip, come on. Let's get moving here." Short, that'll be four. Off the toe of the bat, didn't quite get it, but the result will do.
Mighty close now. A terrific run chase. We've got a nice contingent of Sri Lankan supporters on the hill, and they are jumping for joy. In fact, they've been jumping right through the game, because it's been not one-sided, but from the moment they started, Sri Lanka had purpose.
Oh, that one could be the biggest to finish the game. And beats all the crowd. That's a ripper. What a way to finish it.
Massive.
6-4-6.
Unbelievable.
Well, that's a comprehensive victory for Sri Lanka. There's the captain, Kumar Sangakkara. He'll be delighted with that. Lost the toss earlier this morning, or this afternoon, should I say. Australia batted first. They bowled beautifully. Kept Australia down to 8 for 133. And they've got the runs with, well, 3.5 overs remaining, and finished off with a flurry.
Well, that last one was competing with the fireworks. That was right up there. A huge hit. Went as high as it did far. Pereira doing the job, finishing it off for the Sri Lankans.
Absolutely comprehensive. I was talking about how they took control from the start of the day, taking early wickets. Australia really never would have felt like they were in the game. And in terms of run chase, it doesn't get more comprehensive than that. They had balls remaining and plenty of batting in the dugout as well. They never were tested fully. So more thinking for the Australians and a bad start to their summer.
And here's those last couple of sixes. We're talking about the distance. 123 metres. That's the new leader for this summer. I think it was Michael Clark's 97-metre six earlier today off Murali Duren. But that one's knocked it off by a long way. So they've got it all, Sri Lanka. They've won the game by 7 wickets with 3.5 overs remaining. They've also got the biggest six of the day.
Well, that's what it's all about, you know. At the end of the day, when you're in the bar having your mineral water and your mate comes in and says, oh, you hit a couple of sixes today. And you say, well, you might have hit two, but how long was your furthest? And you know, you want to have 123-metre six, don't you? Tubby, yours would have just crept over. If it was 90 metres, 91 metres, it's still six, but it's not that good.
You don't want to waste your energy, mate. You don't want to waste it. Well, it's been a good day for the Sri Lankans. We'll find out what Michael Clark's got to say. He's with Ian Healy.
Yeah, thanks, Tubbs. Well, Clarkie, could be a tough week. The Sri Lankans, a very complete performance by them.
Yeah, look, they played really well tonight. We're a little bit disappointed with the bat, especially up front, losing 4 wickets quite early. I think a little bit of extra pace and bounce to what we just come from in India. But, look, we have no excuses. We'll outplay tonight. Sri Lanka played really well and deserve full credit.
Yeah, and is it just acclimatising to Australian conditions being in India so long? Or was it genuine confidence and good bowling that did the top order in?
I think we got outplayed tonight. I think no doubt conditions are different to what we've just faced in India, but like I say, we've had great preparation here. The nets are very similar to what we face in the middle, so we have no excuses. Sri Lanka bowled really well, and like I say, we got outplayed tonight.
And what about their stroke play? They looked so confident, Dilshan and Sangakkara, and well, as well as Jay Warner.
Yeah, look, they played really well. They played the crossbat shots really well on quite a bouncy wicket, so I think we can learn from that. I think we bowled, probably tried to bowl a little bit short because there was a bit of bounce and carry, but look, we've got to get up for Wednesday.
Plenty of work to do, mate. Hey, good luck with it.
Thanks, Eels.
And we've got the man of the match. The man of the match, Suraj Randeep. Lovely to meet you. And congratulations. A very happy performance by the Sri Lankans.
Yeah, I'm really happy today because, one, I had a dream to play with our legend Muthaiah Muralidharan together. It's come true today.
Yes, and you've outplayed him. You must have thought, what was the plan bowling off spin in Perth? You're not supposed to spin it and bounce it like that.
Yeah, normally I get some bounce. I try to do my just a bowl and a good line and length, and I think I did well today.
Yeah, well, lots of bowlers have a real tough time finding that line and length here in Perth, but Murali in your corner, it all went well for you.
Yeah, he always with us, giving all the information, giving all the experience that he got, and I just here Perth actually. I had a lot of bounce, more than in Sri Lanka. So, and some a little bit of grip on pitch. So, I did really well.
Yeah, very good. It looked like a very joyous end of the night for the Sri Lankans. A lot of hard work gone into that win. A very good performance by you fellas.
Thank you. Thanks a lot.
Congratulations on your man of the match. Well, it is a very happy Sri Lankan side just behind the camera there. They have put together a great performance after a lot of hard work. After the break, Mark Nicholas is with us to wrap it all up.
The mysterious pain relief powers of the green lipped muscle.
On A Current Affair, does this deep-sea discovery hold the key to relieving and preventing joint pain and arthritis?
I have noticed a difference.
Plus, lost Super Lotto. Aussies hitting the jackpot, finding tens of thousands of dollars they never knew they had.
Do something about it.
We show you how to cash in. And the magic light bulb that lasts 20 years. How it can slash 90% off your lighting bills. A Current Affair Monday.
Mitsubishi delivers outstanding value across the entire range this October. So get into your nearest Mitsubishi dealer and test drive the limited edition Triton Active 4x4. With tub liner, sports bar, tonneau cover, tow bar with rear step and powerful turbo diesel with up to 3-ton towing, just $39,990 drive away. And with Diamond Advantage, Australia's best new car warranty and capped price servicing, Mitsubishi delivers you worry-free motoring. See your Mitsubishi dealer today.
Love that car.
Wave your hands in the air like you just don't care when you win this Casino 8-Spot Jackpot Plus. We're giving away a Nissan Navara, a Whitley powerboat and a $2,800 fuel card to the first three lucky winners. Visit your local Casino venue today. Casino, come and play.
You know that if you come into Bunnings, you can get all the top brands at the lowest prices and know that you're still getting good quality, even though you're paying less.
Stanley 20-piece screwdriver set, $29.94. Dirt Devil vacuum, $129. Pool or garden fencing, $99. Pack of three Sellies liquid nails, $11.50. If you happen to find a cheaper price on a stocked item, we'll beat it by 10%.
Check out our latest catalogue online. Bunnings
Warehouse. Lowest prices are just the beginning.
We were bickering away before we crashed into a farmer's crop.
I was trying to launch my boat.
I was in some kind of choke.
I just didn't see the loving.
What about me? I never claim.
And he gets the same as I did.
What about me?
Amy Safe Driver Awards for drivers who don't claim.
Lucky.
Next, GeForce, your laptop. Next, GeForce, your YouTube. Next, GeForce, your status update. Introducing the Big Pun Ultimate Device. There's nothing faster.
Big Pun Mobile Broadband. $39.95 a month for 7 gigabytes. Plus, get a free Big Pun Ultimate USB on a 24-month plan after rebate for eligible customers.
Fresh has a fresh new look with top quality meats. A sumptuous selection of cheeses, small goods, gourmet meals and salads. A wide range of groceries from Tasmania, Australia and the world. And our fresh fruit and vegetables are second to none. Call in soon. Fresh, from the grower to you.
Hello. Just called to say hello.
He's been hiding a shocking crime until now.
Sorry.
Wins Cops LAC Thursday.
Those are the hard, cold facts of the night. Australia won the toss, batted first, 8 for 133. You never felt it was enough in the face of some impressive Sri Lankan bowling, particularly early on in Australia's innings. Then in response, Sri Lanka, 3 for 135. They strolled home with Kumasanga. It's Kumasangakkara, omnipotent at the end of that Sri Lankan run chase. Some good stuff too from Tilakaratna Dilshan and Mahela Jayawardena. The old hands played beautifully this evening, but the young bowlers held sway. A chastening experience for the Australians. They've had a good year in 2020 cricket, but not tonight. A terrific performance from the Sri Lankans. They've been here, they've prepared properly, and they got the measure of the Perth pitch. Well, very quickly, Australia have a chance to turn things around. The Commonwealth Bank Series begins on Wednesday. We're with you for three matches, one at Melbourne, one at Sydney on Friday, then one at Brisbane on Sunday. The first of them is Wednesday at the Melbourne Cricket Ground. What a week for sport in Melbourne. There's so much going on down there. We're very excited about that, and of course about the start of the Ashes. That's November the 25th in Brisbane. A lot to look forward to on Nine this summer, and the Australians have got to turn it around, and quickly. Good night.
This has been another presentation from Nine's Wide World of Sports.
Wins International Summer of Cricket, brought to you by our telecast partners. KFC, proud to go in and bat for the Australian cricket team. The Next G-Force, now introducing the Big Pond Ultimate device. And our sponsors, The Good Guys, Pay Less, Pay Cash. Amy, lucky you're with Amy. VB, the real beer. Mitsubishi Outlander, love that car. And Bunnings Warehouse, where lowest prices are just the beginning.